I wish I had something I could be like hitting right now during the intro.
He could hit like your face.
I can't hit my own face. That's hard. It's like you can't tickle yourself. You also can't punch yourself in the face. It's impossible.
I'm a ninja.
You're a ninja.
Yeah.
You're like that. Oh, what was there? There was that song a couple of years ago. Your inner ninja.
Is there? How did it go?
Yeah, it was a huge song. I don't know. It was by the guy who sang that flag song for the World Cup.
I guess I'm totally out of touch with popular music. I don't know about the flag song or the ninja song.
Oh, no, this one was by Classified. It's Canadian rap, so most people probably won't have heard it.
Huh.
Let's see if there's any ninja-specific lyrics I can relay to you.
But the song was called Be Your Inner Ninja?
It was just called Inner Ninja.
Ugh.
Yeah. It's real dumb. It's like a motivational, take off
my ninja garb.
Yeah, and talks about how no one's going to see you coming because you're a ninja. Pop music is lame. But most music is lame if you really think about it.
True.
All music is, like, the epitome of what music is try-hards trying hard. Not too cool to try.
To a point. The imagery, for sure, yeah. Okay.
But like the
industry,
the ones who are very good at minimalist music and stuff, they're trying so hard.
Not everybody's trying that hard.
I'm not trying that hard.
There's cool people that aren't trying that hard.
That's not trying hard. I don't think you can find it.
I feel like I don't know. There's a line between people trying hard and just being cool.
Just being cool,
like David Byrne, for example.
He tries real hard.
I don't think he's
cool
trying that
David
hard. He's just weird. He's innately weird.
Yeah, but like he wasn't always weird. He used to just be a drug addict.
That makes you weird. You don't have to try very hard.
But I think he did try pretty hard to get to the point where he's at now of not caring.
I don't know. It doesn't show through, at least.
Hmm. Right, yeah, it's
interesting.
Also,
do you see that?
Like, you see the way he's a well put together guy too. That's trying hard.
I guess, but again, it's pretty minimalistic. Doesn't he just basically always dress in gray suits?
Yeah, but it's a good look. Like to.
But that's not trying very hard.
I think that's
about as basic as it gets.
You have to try. I don't know. I don't think we're gonna agree on that.
I don't think there's the concept of try hard makes any sense at all.
With music, I'm just saying everyone tries hard.
I'm taking off this ninja garb because I can barely talk.
You've probably gotten better at talking with a mask on than you would have been, say, 3 months ago.
Yeah, this is a more intense mask, though. This is like a whole scarf going on.
Like, do people have to have more patience for you saying pardon nowadays when people wear masks all the time?
I think so, yeah.
Like, sometimes going through the drive-thru, I just have no idea what they're saying to me.
Yeah, that's always been the case, though.
I guess, but now it's just twice as bad. There's just like a layer of static on top.
Yeah,
I just have to be like, "What? What are you saying?" Or I just sit there silently until they repeat themselves. Oh,
well, yeah,
that's quite the effort.
There we go. It was worth it. It was hot in there.
Do you think? I mean, if you were a real ninja, you'd probably paint your face black too.
Yeah, right? Probably.
You'd have to, otherwise it's all pointless.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, otherwise you're just gonna like shine.
Yeah, look at those bright eyes.
Although most ninjas probably weren't as pale as I am.
That's true, but most like classical ninjas are more Asian than you are.
Yeah,
that's a little more white at its base.
Yeah, but not nearly as. I don't think it would shine like reflect like mine would.
We'd have to do some problematic skin testing.
They should wear sunglasses too.
Ninjas should all wear sunglasses or goggles.
Yeah. McKinley is in the chat and he loves his space potatoes. He has more potatoes than Russia, he says. 31,400 space potatoes.
I bet you $1 million Russia has more than 31,400 potatoes.
I don't know. I feel like McKinley's done the research.
He did the potato-based research.
Yeah.
Maybe.
McKinley says, ever since I got a balaclava, military gas mask, and tactical vest, he's been tempted to casually walk into a bank with it all to get some money and see what the reaction would be.
I feel like there's got to be, like, the first unexpected bank robbery that happens.
Yeah.
Thanks to this. Because now everyone
I'm surprised it hasn't happened yet, but...
Like, I should... Okay, how about my idea for these face masks? They're all just presidential mouths.
Oh, that'd be good. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's great, because we sell those on Etsy.
Totally. I have, like, a Gerald Ford mouth.
Yeah.
William Howard Taft.
We should get, like, a hilarious cartoonist to draw them.
Political cartoonist creator.
Or are they the real mouths?
Oh, photos? Do we have photos of all the presidential mouths?
I think so, yeah. The question is, can we, like, put them on a mask and make it look good?
And, like, how many presidential mouths could you recognize?
I don't think it's about recognizing. That's
it's just about being weird.
It's about knowing, yeah, you know.
Yeah, that's true. Like, if I had a Jean Chrétien mask, I could recognize that.
Yeah, probably. That's a pretty
recognizable he's got a recognizable mouth.
Yeah.
Has there ever been a president with facial hair?
Yeah, I think so. Lincoln had facial hair, didn't he?
He had the sideburns to, like, the handlebar. He didn't have, like, a front facial hair.
I guess not. The edges. Presidential.
Ulysses S. Grant had the big handlebar, didn't he?
Facial hair. No, Lincoln had a beard, at least at some point.
Oh, he did. He just didn't have a mustache. It was just a beard.
Oh, yeah. And then you had, what's his name?
Calvin Coolidge.
Is that Coolidge?
I don't know.
That fat guy, the walrus-looking guy.
Is that what Ulysses S. Grant?
Here.
Oh, Teddy Roosevelt had the big mustache?
That's who I was thinking of. He looked like a walrus. John Quincy Adams.
Those are sideburns. That doesn't
count. Those are Martin Van Buren. Those are pretty amazing sideburns, though.
But he also, it matches his baldingness, too. Right, very good.
We'll bring everybody in on this.
I feel like Martin Van Buren might be a bit too much of a tryhard with that look.
No, that's not trying hard at all. I don't think we agree on the definition of a tryhard.
Tryhards are just people who try at anything in the least.
Oh, whoops. Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
There we go.
Oh, there you
go. There you are.
I feel like...
That's Martin Van Buren.
With the right dyes and clothes, you could pull that look off. You really have to grow out your hair and dye it white.
I don't know, man. I don't know how you get there.
He kind of has a Scrooge face, actually.
Yeah.
Like, there's a lot of... Like, I would be so lucky to have that many lines and wrinkles in my face someday.
Yeah.
I don't know. Like, everyone's face is just too smooth.
It's just because nobody, old people get plastic surgery and stuff, yeah.
Oh, that's all that it is. Yeah,
that's no fun.
Yeah.
And
even
weird.
Not famous people get plastic surgery.
Yeah. Hmm. Yeah, because he says Lincoln had a beard sometimes, yeah. Yeah, that's Van Buren, and then we got, this is John Quincy Adams, but those are just... Sideburns.
Yeah. I mean, great sideburns.
Yeah. Yeah. That doesn't count.
No.
Zachary Taylor, I guess he had a little mustache there.
I can barely see it. Okay.
Yeah. Lincoln, yeah. That's a classic picture of Lincoln with the beard.
You can't have a beard without a mustache. It just looks crazy. He looks like a monkey if you look at him long enough.
Yeah. It is strange. Oh, Ulysses S. Grant, yeah.
See, like, that's a handsome president.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, Rutherford B. Hayes, there you go. He went full beard.
Isn't he the one who died after, like, 8 days in office or something?
No, he's, I don't know, 77 to 81.
Oh, okay. Wow, so he's in the relatively modern history.
He reportedly wore the longest beard of all the bearded presidents.
Why isn't he number one on this list, then?
Yeah.
Here's the Garfield,
yeah. He went for it.
He looks like a dead person in his picture.
Chester A. Arthur went for just... Wow, he almost had the connected there.
The connected, yeah, real good.
I wonder if he was trying for it and just never made it.
I don't think so, because if you want to do that, you just grow a full beard and you cut out the bits.
You'd think so. So you think he's shaving that one spot there?
Or he just is unable to grow it in the
That's what
chin
I mean.
and cheeks.
Did he want it, but he couldn't do it? Or was he shaving?
This guy does look like he wanted a lot of things that he couldn't do.
Yeah, exactly. I think he was going for the full connect, and he died before it happened.
He's a real yes, ma'am kind of. Yeah. Or yes, m'lady kind of president.
I think these are in chronological order.
Oh, okay.
Like, because it says like the sixth president with facial hair, the seventh president with facial hair.
That would make sense.
Grover Cleveland.
Great man.
He had a mustache. Benjamin Harrison.
I don't know who these people are really.
That's right. There you go. Roosevelt, though. That's a famous mustache right there.
Is he wearing glasses with like a monocle string?
Yeah.
Some crazy
goes
look.
Goes into his vest.
Wow, those have got to come back.
And he says, "I saw a picture of someone who shaved all their facial hair except for the neck beard, so they just had a super long neck beard. What?
Yeah, I've seen
wrong
that.
With
it's
them?
Gross. Yeah.
Why are they doing this?
Just like people who do who shave their head. They like grow everything in, and then they shave their head just so that there's like a ring of facial hair at the front of their head, and everything else is bald. It's
what
the craziest thing.
Wrong with people."
They're the same kind of people that just want to be noticed.
He says in those days, it would have taken a lot of work to stay clean shaven because they didn't have modern razors and stuff.
I think if you're
crazy.
The president, that doesn't matter, though.
I feel like they were still, like, people generally were still pretty, like, I don't know. I don't think beards were everywhere back then.
I feel like there's more beards now than there were then.
Yeah, kind of, yeah. Like people, I don't know. People worked harder to like look good when they left the house. I feel like,
yeah,
because they, you know, they wear a hat.
Yeah, and everyone would look like they're going to church everywhere.
Yeah, exactly. And a suit, you just get fully dressed up just to leave the house.
Yeah. Yeah, because I think if you didn't, you'd just get so dirty that you'd catch sepsis or something.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
And so they, like, I don't know, people must have just spent like a good hour at least every day.
I think just in those days, every mother knew how to cut hair. Like it was just, there weren't like.
No, I think there were
hairdressers
and stuff.
There were barbers, but only for like the rich people because like everyone looked good. Even the homeless.
Yeah. I think I don't think they, I don't know if they look good.
They look well kept.
But they like, yeah, they like cut their hair down.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. They didn't let things go crazy.
Well, even nowadays, like they say you're supposed to get a haircut every 90 days. That's ludicrous. I don't know who does that nonsense.
McKinley wants to have absolutely no facial hair.
That's an achievable
goal. If I want to have absolutely no facial hair, I have to shave 3 times a day. Oh. Well, I mean, yeah.
I mean, you just grow in stubble. That doesn't
I don't know
count.
If you
like,
count it. Yeah, like I wouldn't
no
count
stays.
This. What's happening on my face right now?
That's you're still clean shaven.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, until there's like actual bristles happening.
Yeah, and it's close, but it's like yeah.
Yeah.
But this is interesting. So, Theodore Roosevelt was followed by William Howard Taft, who had a very similar mustache.
Man, but he's like Roosevelt but 4 times fatter.
Yeah, and his mustache is like 4 times as eccentric as well.
It's great. Yeah, he's like a circus master.
Yeah, but it's that's weird. Like the states were just on a kick.
Yeah.
Right then. Mustache kick.
Huh. Crazy.
That's it.
When you think about Justin Trudeau, do you think about him as having facial hair or not? He's kind of reached the point in my mind where he's more facial hair having than he is without.
Yeah, but I still kind of associate it with like a pandemic thing.
Oh, it's his punished Trudeau look.
Exactly. It's a temporary. Yeah.
That's fair.
Yeah.
Yeah, Prime Minister's also not big on the hair.
Yeah.
I think a lot of it comes down to, for the most part,
and
country leaders are always old people. And old
people
don't really
have people. What's interesting
about
this? We got so what's this? The Taft? Or no, yeah, Taft was the last one in 1913. Huh. So it's like it's been over 100 years
since we had
a president with facial hair.
Wow, that's someone needs to run on that platform.
Yeah. Oh shit! Sorry, the intro music's playing.
No to racism. Yes to
facial hair. Yeah, they would win probably with that
totally
platform. That's all you need.
Yeah.
McKinley says by shaving you would increase the chance of getting sepsis because in those days you had to use folding knife razors. Yeah.
I also imagine barbers doing it like those fancy, like barbers have that like leather strap that they do the thing on and then they do it all fancy style. Yeah.
And everybody, maybe everyone just went to barbers. But then you'd have to go like every 2 days. That can't be right.
Exactly. So,
I feel like everyone was just really good. Everyone was just like very practiced at shaving.
Totally. Like even just knowing old people in my life, they all use much more terrifying razors than we have to nowadays.
Yeah, and they still like never screw it up.
Nope, they really didn't.
Yeah.
It's crazy. But so, now with like today's razors, it's almost impossible to screw up.
Yeah. Like, it's a different world now.
Yeah, like there used to be a whole thing about like a dad having to teach his kid how to shave, but now any monkey can figure out how to shave. Those things are just like, they're safe, but they're the sharpest thing imaginable.
Okay, this is, if I remember my social studies 31 correctly, I think Taft was a huge dick who took stuff from the poor to help the rich. Yeah, it sounded like you were right by that little snippet I read there. Sounded like Roosevelt was awesome. Everyone loved Roosevelt. Taft blew it. Everyone hated
him. I don't think Africa loved Roosevelt.
No, I mean the states.
Right. Okay.
Yeah. The world. Yeah.
Yeah, they were a little more afraid of him, but yeah.
Not so much, yeah.
It's one of those weird things, though. Like, before this whole shitty presidency happened now, I would have thought Reagan was one of the most beloved presidents of all time, but he's like either the most hated or second most hated, depending on how you see Trump of all time.
I don't know if he's that hated.
Oh, maybe. Yeah.
He's up there, but he's also pretty... It just depends on what side you're on.
Totally. But just like, I would have thought he was beloved based on everything I had heard about him prior to all this, too.
Well, he is beloved by the Republicans.
By the right. I guess that's true. Man, you shouldn't be allowed to be an actor and a president. That's my controversial.
I don't know. At some point, maybe we should just have it where it's like a face and a brain.
Oh, sure. This child is going to be birthed by the White House, and we're going to raise him as a politician.
I don't know about that. That's pretty creepy.
Oh, it's very creepy.
I just mean like you elect two presidents, the face and the brain.
Right. Oh, sure, that makes sense.
So you elect like an actor to be the face of the country.
Yeah, President Rock.
Yeah, exactly. And then you elect like the actual politician that would like partner with them.
Yeah, I'm fine with that. I couldn't name ultra smart Noam Chomsky. There's my smart person.
They'd be politicians, is what I mean. People who could...
Was he not a politician?
I don't think so.
But he was a political scientist. Is that like, I don't know what the difference is.
I don't know. Yeah, made documentaries.
Yeah.
One of Reagan's aides admitted that he started the war on drugs to increase militancy.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he was pretty gross.
War on drugs was just a racist plot, essentially.
Yeah.
But, like, I guess just those have been happening forever, apparently.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah, it's pretty gross. Turns out when people get power,
it absolutely corrupts.
Yeah, some kind of weird, like, ancient wisdom.
We have to develop a way where all the power is shared by all of the people. Everything is just shared by everyone.
Perfect.
Beautiful. Nothing can go wrong.
No. Oh, man.
There is, when my first time in university, I was a political science major. I am so absolutely happy that didn't happen.
That didn't pan out.
Yeah.
What would you even be doing if it did?
I think the only thing you can do with that is teach, isn't it, also?
I guess. Oh, man. Yeah.
But holy cromoly.
McKinley's just Che Guevara was pretty awesome, especially because he had an awesome hat. Hats who would go a long way, politicians.
Okay, so maybe my platform will be many cool hats and a beard and no racism.
Perfect.
Yeah, but like a new hat every day. I'm going to have like the hat council that I will, it'll be an elected position.
Perfect.
Yeah, I'm going to add one more electoral college.
That'll get you votes. Yeah, people, people are going to vote for that.
Every region will vote for their region's hat.
Oh,
for the
president
to wear, yeah.
And you'll just wear one every day.
Oh, man. That'd be great. Well, yeah. How many states are there? 51?
I think something like that. 50?
And there's 52 weeks in a year, so then I'll also wear a hat for Puerto Rico. So then every week, every state gets a week of hat.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're the next president.
I'm the next president.
I can see it.
Gotta take care of one or two things first.
McKinley says being a teacher of political science would be difficult because you have to fairly grade even people with completely different views as you. Yeah.
Yeah, but then a lot of universities are very left-leaning already. So it's...
Yeah.
But then also a lot of
being
students
a teacher of political science
intentionally...
would be difficult.
Yeah,
be
and
horrible.
I think actually as a teacher of that, you have to like intentionally play devil's advocate a lot.
Yeah, probably.
And that would be awful.
Yeah.
Although there was a point in time where I knew a lot of like conservative people, but conservatism just changed a lot over the past like 10 years.
Yeah. Well, everything's gotten more extreme.
Yeah, exactly.
But the conservatives especially.
Yeah.
Super. Yeah, the extremists, a lot of the extremists are...
It's like in the time of Facebook, all of it's gone crazy.
The what?
Just in the time of Facebook.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, you know, people shouldn't be allowed to broadcast anything. That's the moral
that's
of the story.
The lesson of humanity.
Yeah, you should be allowed free speech, but no one should give a shit what you have to say.
Exactly. Like this show.
Exactly. We'll say anything we want.
Yeah, and nobody gives a shit because nobody's watching.
Exactly. Beautiful.
It's the way it should be.
Huh?
We're doing everybody a service.
That's right.
Paving a new road.
Yeah.
Yeah. McKinley says that if the Rhino Party can manage to get votes, then a hat party could probably as well. Yeah.
I was always so confused by the Rhinoceros Party. Then there was also the Pirate Party.
Says,
like, there was the weirdest.
They're the ones that want to count the Thousand Islands? I have no idea. All I know is the Rhino Party was like a joke.
Yeah, but a joke that people actually spent money to run in.
Yeah.
Like, it's not free to run for office. I don't get it. I just don't understand politics.
But yeah, I don't know if we... Did we even talk about the space potatoes? McKinley mentioned them earlier, but that's our new currency.
Yeah. That's what we got.
Yeah, that's how you spend channel points now. You know, you spend your space potatoes on highlighting messages and stuff. Now we need to think of some rewards.
Make it so if people want to use like pizza and stuff, they have to spend channel points?
I could, yeah.
Right. Interesting. Could you make it so that if they do a version of pizza with channel points, it's louder than a regular one?
I don't know.
That would be exciting.
Looked into that. Like the only interesting thing I could think of, speaking of hats,
yeah,
is that you could make like if you spent it'd have to be a lot of points though,
right?
You could make me put on a hat, and if I was already wearing a hat, I'd put on a new hat. Well, then I'd have a rotation, yeah. Of hats, but I have a pretty big rotation of hats.
You got a lot of hats, but you don't have unlimited hats.
No, I'd have to eventually. I'd restart the circle of hats.
That should be a subscription service.
What
hat of the month? Then just every month you get a hat in the mail.
Oh, that'd be great.
Yeah, but like different styles of hats, not just like ball caps. You'd get like trilbies and I don't know other hats. Cowboy hats. I mean, do you consider a do-rag a hat?
Yeah.
Yeah, so we'll get there someday. And there's lots of other hats.
Oh yeah, we get there's an endless amount of hats.
You could home make a lot of hats
Yeah,
too.
exactly. Almost anything can be made into a hat. Like you can't just put something on your head and call it a hat, but you could fashion anything
But then, like,
into
what
a
about that
hat.
guy? What's that guitar guy? Buckethead? He just has that Kentucky Fried Chicken bucket on his head, and I think that's a hat.
Yeah, that's a hat.
Yeah, so he just put a bucket on his head.
Yeah.
So you almost can just put anything on your head, and it's a hat.
Well, that a bucket is specifically it forms around it, like actually
Oh,
sits on
that's
your head
the
properly.
right. So I could put a lampshade on my head. I could
You could
put, there's
like
stuff.
you yeah, and you could like super glue like something to a bucket.
Oh yeah.
And then you'd have the, you know, like
A fascinator on my bucket.
a shovel hat.
Oh, that would be great.
You just put a shovel on a bucket.
Yeah.
So endless hat possibilities.
Endless hat. The hats never end.
Again, it's just for 50,000 potatoes, we could have to eat 50 pounds of potatoes in a week.
Oh
Yeah.
no. Eat some potatoes in a week. That's the promise I'll make. Someone spends those
Wow.
Spanish potatoes, I'll eat some potatoes
What a
later.
sweet reward.
Yeah.
Not streamed.
Nope, not definitely not
It's
streamed.
just gonna happen sometime this week.
Yeah,
And I guess we'll
exactly.
tell you about
Oh boy, will we ever.
it. We should just have rewards like that. Just do something this week on your
And
own
talk about
time.
it. Yeah.
Yeah. Bring it up later. That'd be
I mean,
good.
really, best case scenario, we fluke into that guy's potato salad Kickstarter.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Man, that guy is the luckiest guy.
Yeah.
Although, I
Think he
wonder what had
gave.
happened with that.
What?
Like, did he end up doing the big live stream of him making potato salad?
I
And
can't remember. I think he gave some of it away too. Can't remember.
it was like
Not sure who.
$100,000.
Yeah, exactly. And at that point, I would feel a little guilty, probably. I'd be like.
But like I would also feel guilty like having a $60,000 potato party.
Yeah.
Like even if I was gonna spend every penny of it on making crazy potato salad, at a
Yeah.
certain point, you're doing more harm than good to the world.
Yeah, and if you can't tell, it's a little potato with a space helmet on. Because
Otherwise, it
that's
would
what.
suffocate.
Exactly. We don't want the potatoes to suffocate in space, and that's where we're from the moon, and that's where potatoes were used as currency all the time.
That's the native homeland of potatoes.
Exactly.
Yeah.
They started from everybody's poo on the
Yeah.
moon.
Yeah. And then we just would pick the poo out of the soil and throw them to Earth. And that's how they got planted on Earth.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, true story. And the good ones we put helmets on.
Yeah.
And yeah. So we thought we'd bring that tradition to our show, and now you can trade space potatoes.
Oh, so the baked potatoes are ones are it's a good one?
Yeah, they're all good ones.
Okay, right. We don't deal with any of the bad space potatoes.
Yeah.
Well, thank goodness for that explanation.
Yeah. Not
Yeah,
much
gentlemen.
going on
There's a
in
big
the
sale on
news.
PlayStation that just started, but there doesn't seem
Oh.
to be anything interesting in it.
Nothing I want. None of the VR
I
games I
mean,
want or the
the VR games included
co-op
in it
games I
are
want.
Wipeout Omega, Thumper, both of which we already own, Dreams for $30, and Ace Combat 7. Yeah, I don't think that's quite worth it. I didn't see any good co-op games either.
No Man's Sky, no.
No Man's Sky. No, there's really nothing. Persona 5 Royal, tempting as always, but still not cheap enough.
We could race that game.
Yeah, you would destroy me. Would it be a race of
That's the
like.
tricky thing. Yeah, we've been looking for games for our new segment where we can race each other, but there's only a very limited amount of games that we can
We
do
could do
because
Resident Evil 5.
they have to be on his on our
Station.
PlayStations. Yeah. You know what I realized? I have RE5 on Steam as well.
Oh wow, I've got it on PS3 and 360 as well, I
Yeah,
think.
you just got a lot of that.
Yeah. I did like Resident Evil 5. It was, other than the ending, it was very good.
Crossplay. Yeah, that was brutal.
That ending was so stupid.
Yeah. Wasn't there a free online race combat game on PS3, says McKinley? I don't know.
Oh.
Isn't Mario Kart Wii have an online multiplayer mode? Oh, like they literally have races? Yeah, but the problem is we want to stream Grimpen's perspective, so it has to be.
Yeah, and I don't have an Elgato myself.
PS4, so. Yeah. But we want to actually like race games.
No, we're racing through like the story mode of something if we both have it.
Yeah, exactly. We both start the game at the same time and see who can get through the game faster.
Yeah.
Or we might do like levels and then like. I don't know. We had
it depends on the game we pick. Like ideally, it's one that we can just charge through. But there's not a lot of those games.
Yeah, exactly. Huh. Well, I don't know. It could suck if somebody gets way ahead.
That's the thing. We might know like 10 minutes in if someone's gonna win.
Yeah, exactly. So it might be more interesting if we hit a point that like we have to stop, and then the person catches up, and then.
Right.
Like they get a point kind of a thing.
Yeah.
And it's like a race to the end. So basically speed running. Yeah, exactly. But just against each other.
And neither of us really know how to speed run.
Yeah, exactly. That's the other tricky part is finding games that were like evenly matched at.
It's true. Because if it's a game that I like a lot, I've already put countless hours.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And yeah, it's.
It's tough.
It is. Yeah. Yeah. I wrote down a fairly big list, but. There's not a ton of like great options on it.
Yeah.
And Elgato McKinley A asks is a is just what lets us stream like without going through the system.
Yeah, it lets you get a video signal out of a console onto a PC.
Right. So we can stream like older systems, GameCube, and all that. We don't have to use the PS4 to actually stream stuff. We can use the Elgato.
But I do.
Yeah, but he doesn't. We only have one.
Yeah, exactly. Pretty expensive. The Switch doesn't have any kind of streaming in it, no, right?
I don't think so.
No.
Yeah.
No, it doesn't even have a Twitch app, so it wouldn't.
Yeah. Yeah, but we're working on that for your entertainment, your guys' entertainments.
I would say more so for our entertainment, too.
I'm trying to make us look good.
Yeah, no, that's fair.
Yeah.
That's a good point. Like, one that would be interesting is EDF.
I was thinking about that, but I don't know how.
Yeah, how and do that's that. Also more fun to just play together. Too,
yeah, that's true. Yeah. I know. I don't know how that one works.
Yeah. Evil Within 2 is on sale all the time. That we could try that. Both of us have the same amount of experience with it.
Yeah, it's
but
tricky.
I think that's like a fully open world game.
Yeah, exactly. So. And the bigger the game gets too, it's harder.
Yeah.
Like as far as full fledged games I had on here, like Dishonored is one of the more interesting ones.
It's true, but I think I know that too well.
I was gonna say
I've beat it like 5 or 6 or 7 times.
A lot more than me. But if it's just running through it.
Yeah, it's true.
It's not.
But then
like,
there's also like. The Dishonored Death of the Outsider or whatever is on sale all the time for like $7. We could just get that next time it goes on sale, and that's something neither of us have even tried.
Oh yeah, that'd be interesting. Yeah,
that'd be an interesting one. Yeah,
I don't know if I.
Huh. Next time I see it, I will let you know. It's just it's difficult.
Yeah, exactly. Super Time Force Ultra is one that I know too well.
Oh yeah. Like Tetris Effect would be very cool, but that game never goes on sale.
Yeah, that's one I don't own. Yeah.
Contras.
Yeah, I had Contra on there. That's an interesting one.
Yeah. But yeah, it is tough because it's basically just like a new beaten into submission.
Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah. Huh.
Yeah, interesting stuff, but we'll talk about that later. McKinley says, maybe the old Super Mario game. See, that would be perfect. I would love that, but we can't. We have no way to
know what we should do if they put out a Mass Effect remastered.
Yeah.
We should do a simultaneous play where I'm playing the new one and you're playing the old ones, and we go Renegade and Paragon, and we can like do the same things at the same time and swap between them.
That would be so awesome too. I want to do that too with like Final Fantasy VII and.
Oh, was there other? Oh, you mean playing the old one? Yeah, that's
yeah.
Like... But that would have ended up not working, right?
I don't know. Yeah, it would have you'd have to, the person playing the old one would end way sooner. Yeah, or it would have to go way slower.
Right.
Would have to like
just level up to 99 by the end.
Or we just have to like, yeah, like when stuff's happening that's not in the old one, they just have to stop and then wait till it catches up, kind of a thing, and then
yeah.
So that we could experience both at the same time and compare them.
Yeah.
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
Totally.
But we should play. We should get into gaming history. Lacko's here. Hey, Lacko.
I'm just looking at games I have.
That's what I did last night. I wrote a list
with hope in my eyes.
But we're gonna play some Metroid first.
Probably starting with the other M.
Yeah. So cool. Let's do it.
Chick chick boom.
This week in gaming history.
Is it a good story or is it just...
Hey, it's gaming history.
Oh, bullshit, that doesn't matter.
I'm going to change the title here. But yeah, it's Metroid Other M.
Do you ever find out what the other M stands for?
I don't think so. I think. Okay, I'm gonna type it and see what the internet says. But I always thought it was seriously supposed to stand for motherhood.
Huh. My guess is it stands for Metroid.
Metroid, other Metroid.
Yeah, that would be great. I don't even think this answer is gonna be there though.
Other mother,
you were right.
Yeah, it's another mother brain.
Oh, there you go. That's not as cool as Metroid Other Metroid.
But this, this is, the Metroid series is relatively famous. It's one of Nintendo's darker and more atmospheric series. And this is like the last... It's not the last game they made in the Metroid series, but it's the last. It's the last time they tried to progress the story forward.
Right,
and they really tried with this one.
Huh.
That's what makes it significant. It's the series producer, the guy who's directed basically every 2D Metroid, and he just decided for this one he wanted to dive deep into who Samus is and her entire story
and her other mother.
And that's what kind of got the caused a lot of controversy. But it was made by Team Ninja, and they really tried to translate the old 2D Metroid games into like a 3D action style, and it's crazy. It's a crazy game.
So what is the 3D like? What's 2D? Well, we're going to see, I guess. It's a silly thing to ask.
Lacko says it's really good. Lacko's a fan. It's kind of
a first-person shooter, isn't it?
Yeah, that's the part. Those parts don't really work for me that well.
Huh.
But, yeah, I'm just going to start it off here. It goes right into the story.
Sweet. You want to switch to OBS?
I'm on
OBS. Oh, you're in OBS. Never mind.
Make it
bigger. We weren't a minute ago in it, yeah. Oh, I've also learned I can zoom in on my phone now too, but only sometimes.
I also enjoyed this game too. It's it gets a lot of love, but it also gets a lot of hate. It's definitely one of the most divisive Metroid games in the series.
It was also very cool to hate Team Ninja at the time.
Yeah.
Like, they had kind of worn out their welcome at that point.
I don't know. I feel like this was kind of before that.
Was it?
Like, I think it was before Ninja Gaiden 3.
Oh.
I don't know.
Huh.
I remember being excited Team Ninja was working on this game.
Right. Who is this?
That's Samus. I don't get this beginning, to be honest. I don't know. I don't get that at all. But I guess that was all happening inside her head. This is actually the finale of Super Metroid. This is a direct sequel to Super Metroid.
Like, it picks up right after?
Yeah.
I don't remember what happens at the end of Super Metroid either, but...
The baby, Samus' Metroid baby...
Oh, yeah.
...saves her. That's Mother Brain.
Right.
That's Samus, and the Metroid is holding her and takes the blast.
Yeah, okay.
So it's like a full 3D recreation of the end of Super Metroid.
Weird. And what was Mother Brain? She's the mother of the Metroids or the leader of the space pirates?
Oh, I think the leader of the space pirates. Yeah, I think you're right. I've never understood the Metroid.
Ridley also mother or leader of the space pirates?
The stories of Metroid. I'd never really gotten into them.
Right.
This game definitely tried to like catch everybody up, but I don't really remember it either. Because it felt like it over-tried. It over-explained everything.
Yeah.
So it didn't really click. The story didn't click with me either for this one. It was mainly the gameplay that I really enjoyed. McKinley says, if this one is first person, then what differentiates it from the Prime series? It's not first person. It just has a first person mode. And they really tried to make it as simple as possible. So they insisted on only using the Wii Remote. That was also kind of a bad decision.
Oh, no nunchuck at all.
No nunchuck.
What?
Their goal was to make it as simple as possible. And so first person mode actually happens when you move the remote and point it towards the screen. It goes into first person, and then you can't move. You just move around, you aim, and shoot.
Does it have scanning?
I believe it does. There's some I read in this thing that it was like that was the biggest thing that they were inspired by the Prime series about. It was like, yeah.
Sweet. I mean, she looks more like Zero Suit Samus in this than in any other Metroid game, right? Thanks to the
hyper beam. Yeah, I guess so. I mean,
the hair. This is the suit you use in Smash Bros.
Yeah, totally.
Huh.
I don't know. The Game Boy Advance remake, the Zero Mission game. That I don't know which came out first, but that also had the Zero Suit. The exact same. McKinley wants a Metroid game where instead of losing your powers at the beginning, you have every power from every Metroid game and all the upgrades. Well, that kind of defeats the purpose.
It would be just go anywhere. It would be New Game Plus.
Yeah. I do. I have said before that I do want... I've said a similar thing. Or I want a Metroidvania game where you feel as powerful as you do at the end of a game at the beginning. And then you go from there.
You have to be so inventive with future powers is the thing.
And you get, like, new...
Yeah. Axiom Verge is kind of that, actually.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, where, like, you start with a double jump and all kinds of cool guns, but then you, like, learn ways to, like, manipulate the world.
So these, all those anime, all those cutscenes were made by a different company called D-Rockets.
Are you sure it's not Drockets?
Yeah, well, there's a hyphen.
Oh.
Yeah. Watcha!
And like you're playing, this is 2D gameplay right now. Like, how's this working?
Pretty much, yeah. I only got the directional pad, but no, it is 3D. Like, I can still go.
Oh, okay.
Diagonally.
But you have no camera control.
Still have 8-way moves, but yeah, no camera control.
Weird.
And things just automatically lock on, which is actually pretty awesome.
Yeah, that's great. Because Metroid's never been about difficult combat.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And there's something about the way she moves in this game I always liked. I guess that's the kind of the Team Ninja feel.
And she also looks like she moves like in Smash Bros.
Well, a lot of it was based on Other M because it's like this is the last appearance. This is the last time that they attempted to like evolve her look or anything.
Interesting. It doesn't look like they evolved her look too much.
Well, like you say, though, still... she, like they.
Or she has, yeah, zero suit, but like she's still definitely Samus.
Oh yeah, totally. Yeah. They she's just a bit sleeker, a bit less bulky.
Yeah.
Than right. She is in.
Does she have huge tits?
I don't think so. Did she ever?
Well, no, but this is a Team Ninja game.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
No, I think they used some restraint there.
Oh man.
I guess Nintendo probably asked them.
We don't. We just want moderate size breasts, please.
Weirdly, a location from this game appeared in a Dead or Alive game on the 3DS.
Huh.
And you could press. Like Samus and Ridley would show up in the background and run around.
That's cool. I can't believe there's a Dead or Alive game on the 3DS.
Team Ninja was like really excited, apparently. Like the director, the guy who was directing all the Team Ninja stuff, was just a huge Metroid fan.
Okay, huh.
So it was just really passionate about it. Let's check your reaction. Again, he says, is that what Team Ninja is known for? Did they make Tomb Raider?
DOA. Yeah, so bouncing boobs is their calling.
Yeah, Dead or Alive, kind. Yeah.
And then kind of DOA Extreme Beach Volleyball more so than anything.
And Ninja Gaiden.
Oh, and Ninja Gaiden. Yeah.
Yes.
But they got their whole reputation for being... Like, Ninja Gaiden fully falls into that trap, too. Of just... The women are just eye candy in the story.
Oh, totally,
not,
yeah. It's totally
not
guilty
good-looking
of that.
Eye candy. It looks terrifying.
Yes.
Like, they have such a strange idea of beauty.
Yeah. Honestly... That feels great, but, too.
If there's no latex in this game, I would say that would also be self-restraint.
Yeah, like, there's no Ninja Gaiden tits. Only normal tits, please. That's probably the first thing Nintendo said.
Yeah.
Yeah, like,
remember
that's
the old
weird,
DOA
like,
commercials?
You can get your missiles back by holding the Wii remote up and pressing A. Find it for me,
yeah. So it's like
go,
a time splitter. Or time,
there's first-person right. mode.
Interesting. I wonder if there's a way to see her face, like in Metroid Prime games.
I don't know. I don't even know how to shoot.
You're in search of you. Buddies is lurking here somewhere. No shooting.
Oh, I gotta find somebody?
Yep.
Where's one of my pesky buddies? Be up on the roof or something? Oh, there he is.
Is that a bad guy or a good guy?
Okay. One of my pesky buddies.
What's a pesky buddy? Is that like a Tamagotchi?
Oh, I ticked him off.
Gosh.
Oh, no. What am
so
I?
Then,
oh, wait, right. I want to not be in my first person mode.
So is there like punching and kicking too?
Yeah, but you don't really. It's all. That part's more automatic.
I see.
It's so cool. It's actually pretty great. Like, and if you're holding down your shoot button, which is also what charges you up, you'll like dodge small attacks.
Huh. Interesting. Like, it's like when you're running in a Star Wars game and it automatically deflects your lightsaber.
Yeah, kind of.
Yeah.
Powerbomb!
Allow adequate room around you during powerbomb.
Good thing they put the blast shields down.
Definitely.
Looks like you took quite a bit of damage. I think it says they could make a good. They should make a VR Metroid game. It'll have to be only first person, so no ball form and stuff.
That's true. And that, take that out, and that's not very Metroid.
Right, yeah. Big dogs are waiting. Yeah, you couldn't really. You'd have to do like a Metroid experience. That guy looks evil.
Not even
than a fragment. None of the baby remained on me.
None of the baby remained on me.
I knew it to be true, but still couldn't help looking at
really well written.
Never again would I encounter
the... But that's what I expect. The last known Metroid is in captivity. Like, it's always been dumb garbage.
Yeah, it's just, yeah, it's like... I guess it's interesting, like he... The guy behind Metroid, one of the main guys behind Metroid, his name was Yoshio Sakamoto.
Yeah.
And he wanted to flesh out Samus so that people felt more connected to her and would be more interested in seeing her go on new adventures.
Right.
And ironically, that deep dive into Samus is kind of what...
Killed interest.
There hasn't been a...
Nope.
Metroid game since then about new adventures that Samus goes on.
Metroid is fun to be in, like, a really foreign environment exploring.
And that's the thing, like, he was like, oh, Metroid, like, Samus has so far been so mysterious, and, like, in the past they actually wanted her to be mysterious.
Right.
And so he was like, wouldn't it be interesting to dive into her lore and stuff? And it's just...
She's just a bounty hunter, right?
Keep it mysterious. Yeah.
Yeah.
I actually don't even know. Like, not even. I haven't looked into it that much, but apparently most of the, like, backstory about her childhood and stuff was told in, like, mangas. In Japan.
I'm never going to see that. Specifically for me.
It was crying specifically for me. Like a mother. You can play as a side character or something, like Space Marine. That's exactly what people hated about...
Three.
Federation Force. That's called too. On the 3DS.
Yeah.
Yeah, Metroid's had a hard time. I don't know why...
They just haven't figured out what's so great about it.
I guess, yeah. Sakamoto went to Team Ninja...
Yeah.
To make this game, because his team is basically the 2D Metroid team. Like, they made all the 2D Metroids, and so he was a little worried about them doing like a 3D game out of nowhere. So he went to Team Ninja to do all the programming and 3D models and stuff.
Weird.
So I don't know why that team doesn't consistently produce 2D Metroid games.
Yeah, it's true.
They don't need to reinvent the wheel every time.
No, they've made good ones. Like, wasn't the Metroid Prime 2 or Metroid 2 remake really good?
Yeah, I guess, yeah. Yeah, make a whole new Metroid in that style for the Switch.
I wish.
Yeah.
I mean, it took, what's his name? Iga leaving Konami to be able to make what he wanted as well. Like, it's clearly the big company saying, don't do this.
Is it, though? Because this was all Sakamoto.
That's true.
Like, Sakamoto had total freedom on this thing.
I don't know. Sakamoto thinks we love Samus, so maybe he doesn't know what he's talking about.
I mean, they made a great game. That's the thing. And it got, like, pretty good reviews. It sat at... it's sitting at 79 on Metacritic.
That's not bad.
Just shy of 80, yeah. And it got lots of praise for its gameplay and its design.
Yeah.
But it got lots of critiques for its story and for its way it represented Samus.
Huh.
Oh, can I look at that?
Galactic Federation.
Oh, yeah, this is like, yeah, even a 2D perspective.
Like, the parts where it's not first person look pretty good.
It even looks good, yeah.
Yeah.
It holds up even in the look department. But it also plays...
Do you end up going to, like, a planet eventually?
It also plays really good, too.
Right.
Yeah, you totally do. There's, lab areas and...
Right. Eventually it becomes a Metroid game.
Yeah. Yeah, it's just weird because you do the whole thing with, like, the Galactic Federation.
Right. And I guess ever since 3, they want us to care about that.
Anthony. Yeah.
There's only one person who calls me
princess. There's only one person who calls me princess.
Is Anthony Hicks of the Galactic Federation. That's Anthony Hicks. Link. Anthony Hicks. I've seen you since that last mission. Hey, and
your buddy's here too. I remember people somewhat pushing for Anthony Higgs as a Smash Bros. Character because it was like the only one of the only other Metroid characters with like a face and a name.
That has to be a joke though, doesn't it?
I think people, the Metroid fans, they don't have that much representation in Smash Bros. They do now, now that Ridley finally came through.
As the result of a certain incident.
But before it was just two Samuses. I left Adam's
command. But like, yeah, I just, there aren't very many interesting Metroid characters is the problem. They should just have a whole bunch of Metroid levels in Smash Bros. What are you
doing here? That'd be cool.
I'd be fine with that.
The one, the one in Smash Bros. Ultimate, the I guess it was in 3DS and Wii U first, is the Pyrosphere, the one where Ridley shows up. That's from this game. That information is not. Nagus's Federation Force was a betrayal. Well, the last one for 3DS was good. The Samus Returns. Well, it's weird now. It's split into these two. It's the two teams now. There's Sakamoto's team that does the 2D ones, and then I can't remember the other guy's name, but he was a producer on all the retro games, and now he's in charge of the like Prime series of Metroid games. Remember, we were talking about him last week because we were playing Metroid Prime last week. We were playing Metroid Prime 3, and we talked about how Metroid Prime 4 was started by him, and then Nintendo rebooted it at the beginning of this year, and it's gone back to Retro Studios to finish Metroid Prime 4. But I'm assuming the Sakamoto's team is still working on, is probably working on something. They must be working on a Switch 2D Metroid game. They must be.
Right? They have to.
They'd be fools not to.
We said that. We said that about on the. I don't like. I want to believe.
But like Samus Returns, that was a while ago.
Yeah, that's true. On
the 3DS. Whoa. Okay, Anthony. My king.
Oh, wow.
I don't know. What does she call him?
I guess, yeah. Right. She probably calls him daddy. That seems like.
He calls her princess.
Yeah.
And yeah, this whole thing. I remember playing this actually and thinking if you literally just cut out all of Samus's internal dialogue, you'd have a. Like significantly better story, and it still wouldn't be great. But
is she just talking in the background all the time as you're playing, or
no? She's just like even right there. She was like that whole thing of like nobody. The only one person calls me princess.
Right.
That was all in like internal monologue.
Oh yeah, nobody needs that.
And it, yeah, you could cut that out, and it would just like it would make again make Samus a bit more mysterious.
Yeah.
But it would just, yeah, it'd be better.
Well, that's the thing. Mysterious and badass are very similar things.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, whoa! This just sort of shatters the illusion that she's actually kind of cool. Instead, she's just someone who has a space sergeant she calls Daddy.
Workball. Oh, see? Like, that's insane. I tried to use a bomb. Adam has not yet authorized the use of bombs.
Who's Adam?
That guy.
That's the lieutenant?
Isn't that... Yeah. Yeah.
Oh. Why... So this is actually a story about, like, male dominance over the female body?
That, well, that's another... People... People got mad at it for that reason. It took a, kind of took away Samus's independence.
It's stupid that you have these abilities, you're just not allowed to use
them. Well, exactly. And like at one point, like the one that stands out the most is the when you get to the lava area.
Right.
And you just can't go through it.
And it's just because Adam's like, I don't want you to.
Yeah.
Is it always Adam?
Yeah. Oh, it makes sense. I thought it was Anthony, not Adam. Yeah, I think you might be right. Adam's, I guess, your commander.
Okay. It's a bad thing. Just take your power. Have you get your suit broken or something, and you have to get them repaired. Like, do that at least. Then it doesn't make her seem like some kind of weird robot.
Yeah. It's
wait, weird. You can jump in the morph ball?
Yeah.
That's new, isn't it?
It's weird. Some Metroid games have it and some don't.
I mean, morph ball, like, doing the, like, double bomb jump with a morph ball was always the hardest thing to do in Metroid.
I never found it that hard.
It's the trickiest strategy. And there were people who could do it, like, unlimitedly, too, to, like, just climb up walls.
I don't know where I'm supposed to go here.
Call Anthony.
Anthony. I'm gonna use my bombs.
Shut up!
Oh, is there a hole here or something? No.
I mean, there's definitely a glowing dot on your map.
I know, but what is it? That's right here.
And it's like in the middle of the floor.
Maybe I can like look around in first person?
Yeah.
No.
Marco says you must scan.
Must scan?
Yeah.
Did they teach me how to scan?
I don't know. Has Adam allowed you to scan?
That's weird. Jump in first person.
I could also jump in first person.
Lucky.
Yeah. Could you imagine if there was an option in life to view yourself from the third person?
Oh, I found something.
You found something? Did you just have to scan?
Oh, but I need a more normal bomb.
What's a normal bomb?
Like just a...
What do you have? You have like special
no
bombs?
No bombs.
Oh, no bombs.
Unless...
Man, your bombs just aren't normal enough.
I don't get it. McKinley's had dreams where he's in third person. That's fun.
That would be cool. I like if someone came up to you and offered you a permanent change in your life from first person view to third person view, would you take them up on it?
No, that'd be pretty creepy, I think.
It would be crazy. Like I said, the green spot maybe? Yeah, that pile of slime. You gotta scan that slime pile. I agree with Lacko.
Huh. I can lock onto that, but it doesn't tell me anything about it.
Hmm. Nothing in the pile of slime?
Oh. Nothing above the pile of slime. Feels like I should be able to get through there.
Yeah, kind of does. Like it looks, especially with jumping, it looks like you're fully clearing it.
Yeah.
All right, I guess I'll try and look up on a guide, but I don't know what this is even.
The first 2 seconds. Adam, just give me bomb powers. Can I call Adam or something?
Are you still in chapter one?
I think so.
Chapter one is called Baby's Cry.
Yeah. Like it says, watch the green slime. And I watch that green sign. Hey, dude, boy. Oh, he's being a secret. Dude? Being sneaky. Oh, he's a ninja.
Are you done training?
Yeah.
Okay. When training complete, sit back for another lengthy cutscene. Did you get...
hole I'm missing somewhere?
Oh, yeah. You delivered your mission of the report of the destruction of Zeebs, right? That's the end of Super Metroid, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Was this just describing story to me? So this is not a great guide so far.
And in the corner, says that go? This corner? Oh, yes. It seems to be something. Oh, I think it, I guess it's above me, though.
Looking at a parked dropship? Is that what you're supposed to do?
No,
is there a parked dropship in the room?
Oh, wait, what's that? What? No, I don't know. Did I hear what Dubaro says? Did we hear about Pokemon Masters EX? Because they did not do
Pokemon Master Sex?
A good hashtag on Twitter with it. Pokemon Master Sex.
Yeah. Cheering for their favorite Pokemon Masters.
They blew that.
Their sex competition.
Hey, Green Rabbit. With his psychic power grimping emote. I think I'm before looking at that.
There's no description of gameplay prior to.
Okay, then maybe I'm after.
Let's get started with the first one. The second one is to take a close look at the starship and search for something that identifies the owners of the ship. Is there a starship? Is there a plane in the room you're in?
I don't think so, no. I've fallen down somewhere. Like, I fell down and then fought a bunch of flies.
I don't think this guide's going to help. You've already met Anthony Higgs at this point.
Yes.
Huh. I have no idea. Okay.
We're doing pretty good, Green Rabbit. How are you doing?
Have you played Metroid Other M before Green Rabbit? What are we supposed to do?
Yeah, we're doing good besides being stuck in Metroid. Because Adam is not yet authorized the use of bombs.
The guide doesn't help me. I wasn't paying enough attention to cutscenes before. Right. What happens if you like push start? Is there any kind of like hints?
No, it's a map.
Oh. Don't use the walkthrough on retropixel.net. It's nonsense.
I'm watching a video walkthrough.
Oh, that's crazy town.
Like 2 seconds. Like so at the beginning of the game. Here we go. Okay.
You had to shoot it with a charge blast. I guess.
That was it.
I didn't even know you could charge. I didn't know Adam had let you. Well, Metroid's hard.
You know what? I got stuck in almost every Metroid and have to use a guide.
They are tricky, but it's usually a weird... Metroid, more than other Metroidvania games, has, like, you have to go through some secret walls at some point, usually.
Yeah. I find it's usually something that you've always been able to do. They just never told you you could.
Like the one in Super Metroid where you have to do the run and jump straight up.
That's exactly what I'm thinking of.
Yeah. You're supposed to learn that you can do that from the animals that are there, apparently.
Oh, yeah. Right, yeah. And it was just cool, but...
Sure, but yeah. That's a nonsense thing.
Oh, right on my face.
What are they, space birds or bats?
They're bugs.
Oh, bugs. Gross. I mean, bats are bug adjacent.
Like, it gives you the same feeling as a 2D Metroid where you're just running and shooting for no reason.
Right.
And it feels great.
Totally. Are there like hidden walls in this, like in a 2D Metroid? Scan this.
Oh. I think so. Oh, definitely. Yeah, I should say.
Right.
There's cool. definitely like hidden missile increases and stuff.
Right.
So dark.
It's so dark. I see you in the center of the screen, and then just lights coming out of you.
Another crazy thing about this game is there's a glitch that's still in it because the Wii didn't have patches.
Right.
So there's a glitch at a certain point if you backtrack without like passing a certain point. You won't be able to pass a certain point. And so they actually made it so you could send in your SD cards to Nintendo and they'd fix
That's crazy.
They'd fix your save file.
They would just put a patched version of... Oh, they'd fix your save file. They don't even patch the version on your memory. Wow. So you can, like, soft lock your game?
Yeah.
Huh.
Fairly easily, I guess. Just crazy. By like, I guess when you get the ice beam, if you backtrack to a certain room,
you think you could still do it?
I'm sure you could still trigger the glitch. There's
not. You think you could still send in your memory card?
Oh, I doubt it.
It'd be great if there was just one Nintendo employee whose job was just to wait for memory card fix other M saves.
He's been waiting for so long.
Yeah. At one point, he got like 20 or 25 a day, but now it's like 2 a year.
McKinley says, "Can you just start a new game?" Yeah, you can just start a new game.
Yeah.
It's probably taking the same amount of time as sending in your. Or probably faster to start a new game.
I'm sure it's faster.
Stand on the platform.
Although, like, are cutscenes in this game unskippable?
Huh, it's weird. Like, you actually go into first person to like trigger, like looking at like to trigger buttons and stuff.
Oh yeah, like, that makes sense.
Yeah, it's a very strange game. It was over a team of over 100 people for over 3 years in like three different studios. You had Nintendo, and you had the animation studio D Rockets, and you had Team Ninja.
That's sweet. It's a lot of people.
Yeah.
But then it turns out all anyone wanted was either a 2D Metroid or a new Metroid Prime game.
Pretty much. I think they could have knocked this out of the park, for even for fans, if they didn't focus as much on the story. If it was all the same gameplay,
yeah,
but just a game where you just explored a planet and it felt more like a classic Metroid game,
right.
I think it would have been received a lot better.
Are the boss fights interesting? Like, Team Ninja does have interesting bosses.
Yeah.
Huh. Like, that's what I'd be curious to see. So hopefully you can reach a boss.
Lyle! Enough! It's just a bug! Get away from me! There was some pervasive danger. It was obvious there was some pervasive danger. Yeah. But I don't want to ever hear what Samus has to think ever again after this game.
He remembers how in Metroid Fusion he had to use a guide at one point because he couldn't figure out what to do. It turned out he had to use something called a screw attack to destroy a specific block. Yeah, the screw attack is also something they never super clearly explain.
Yeah.
You can double jump forever with the screw attack.
It's usually, I find like somewhere near the beginning for me too, I usually get stuck.
Right.
I think when I played Zero Mission, I came really close a bunch of times, but never actually used the guide.
Huh. But Zero Mission is like...
More modern.
That game has been gameplay tested to hell and back because it's based on such an old thing, yeah.
Whoa, this is such a Team Ninja enemy.
It's true.
Just a goop guy with one eyeball and arms that slap. Flop
Man,
around.
These arms sure do slap.
Oh, shit.
I don't think I needed a guide in Metroid Prime either. the first one. The second one I did, because the second one got hard and complicated.
Oh, yeah, maybe not.
But the first one was pretty
simple. I might have, though. Wow! This ain't
good. Cool action.
Yeah, Silent Mist is such a badass.
Lyle!
Oh, she just authorized our freeze guns.
Can we go soft lock our game?
Still no... Oh, and my missile use. Thanks. Thanks, Prince. Oh, I got slapped.
Do you think he's based on Prince the musician? Probably is.
Well, I just made that up, so I don't think it is based on Prince the musician.
I bet he is.
Based on... Oh, you mean this enemy?
The character. The
guy
prince.
That I'm calling Prince?
Yep.
Oh, we froze his arm, and then we shot it. Wrecked the goop. Freeze the goop, and then... destroyed.
Put that goop in your drink, and it's a delicious ice cube.
Oh, yeah. Whoa! Some guy just, like, crawled up on his face.
Whoa.
What was he thinking?
That's Lyle for ya.
Oh, Lyle. So crazy. Yeah! Whoa! Oh, this is like a enemy from Clay Fighter.
Kind of. Like, he does look made by a child.
Blasted him in the eyeball. Oof.
Like, is floppiness his only power?
What?
Is floppiness his only power?
Yeah, pretty much. It's slapping. Huh. Floppy slaps. Oh, it's his eye. His eye is a bug.
Ooh.
I killed it.
And now he's a friendly floppy slapper. You just have to kill that bug in his eye.
Now we can be best friends. I can drink him every day. Samus.
Hell yeah.
Looks like I'm going to need to ask for your cooperation on this mission.
Oh, finally.
I'm going to have to ask that you follow my commands.
Oh, man. You don't move, but I'm a renegade.
Fire until I say so.
You don't move unless I say so. You don't fire unless I say so. Man, he's so bossy. That's Adam.
You're taking all of his permissions back. No more moving and no more firing.
Oh Adam calls me lady? The thumbs up sign had been used in the Galactic Federation for ages. Oh. She gave a thumbs down during a briefing.
It was like sideways and down. I had my reasons, though. Like, her thumb was down, but her fist was sideways.
Oh, maybe she hasn't made up her mind yet.
Oh, she just has a really heavy thumb.
Yeah.
He was joking, but others weren't. At the time, I felt surrounded by...
Because this is, if you hadn't agreed to follow his commands until now, then why were you not using his stuff without permission before that? I think, yeah, it's a whole story, but she, like, left the Galactic Federation to be an awesome bounty hunter, but now she has to work with them for this mission they probably explained it.
And she has to respect their rules?
Well, that's what he just said. He was like, if you're going to work with me, you do everything that I tell you to. My thumbs down was a twofold response. Like, wow. They over-explain everything too. Like they could literally just show her doing that, and you'd be like, okay, yeah, I kind of get the character.
She's
and not have any of this dialogue. That I clearly had so much yet to learn. Among them was Anthony. In the face of his well-meaning behavior, McKinley says, "I think in Metroid Fusion, it said she was an ex-Federation trooper, right? So this is when she was a trooper." She would give some things down, a thumbs down.
So Metroid Prime 3 takes place before this?
What?
Metroid Prime 3 takes place before this?
Yes. Yeah, as far as I know.
And she's part of that Federation super team, isn't she?
Yes. Yeah. But I think that's all the... I think all the characters in that are like bounty hunters or something. Like, I don't think any of them work for the
Feds.
Federation, yeah.
Adam knows my past.
I can't remember. This story, who knows?
Also, who cares?
The story is very.
Yeah.
Because I was so young.
Yeah, exactly. It's not that important to Metroid.
Hokey at best.
I love Metroid games. I played almost all of them. And I have no idea what the story's about. I don't care.
No. Why you Metroids hate Samus so much?
Yeah. I don't care. Why? What's the deal with the space pirates? I don't care.
Yeah, she's like an ancient chorizo.
Yeah, I don't care. That's cool. I know she's she's cool and badass and has powers and stuff.
I mean, it's maybe it has more to do with the genre, because Metro in Castlevania also. I don't care about the story.
Yeah, it's true. And Castlevania's always tried.
It's true. And the more they try, the less I like it.
Yeah, it's true.
Well, like Bloodstained also, the story was non-hot trash.
Yeah. Can't even follow it.
Just wanted to do the fun gameplay, shooting pit.
Exactly. The equipment we thought had been destroyed is operational again. Okay, this is the chronological order of this series is almost as confusing as Metal Gear.
Metal Gear, I could at least, just by listing them off, I could tell you the order where they go. Metroid, no chance in hell.
No, there's so many spin-offs and stuff of Metal Gear. Extremely dangerous.
But like 1 through 5, we would know the order.
Yeah, but like if you the full chronology though.
Oh sure, yeah. Yeah, I guess because some of the games even have things take place in multiple times.
Right.
Like, but I have the DVD. I've got the DVD. It's got all that information in it.
Yeah, that's what I think McKinley's talking about, is the chronological order being super confusing.
It was called, like, the Document of Metal Gear Solid.
Yeah.
You cover Sector 2. That was fun.
Oh, wow. We got a whole team breakdown here.
Any of them have hilarious names, like Lyle? I'll leave it to you to decide whether Plasma Gun... Sector J. All right, James. Check out the control bridge.
Communication issues. James. Metal Gear also had some retcon stuff, and sometimes it has supernatural stuff, and sometimes it doesn't.
No,
it's not Metroid.
The only supernatural stuff, as far as I know, in Metal Gear is actually Vamp being a vampire. Isn't everything else explained away with hot bullshit?
I don't know. I think there's some more than that, but I can't remember.
I mean, a lot of it is technology taking the place of magic.
Yeah.
What was 5 about? If I asked, if you had to tell me what 5 was about.
Oh, I have no idea. So a guy who...
voices,
as far as your other weapons go, everyone thought he was dead, and so they made some kind of like shadow military.
That's all I remember. That's like the overarching story.
Yeah, that's literally all I remember. Yeah.
Right. So like, what were we doing in Africa? What were, like, remember the guy with the skull mask? And
I barely even remember like the villains. Yeah.
No, I don't remember really anything that happened.
Phantom Pain had a fire guy, says McKinley. I don't remember. Yeah. Snake Eater had a weird plant sniper who was hundreds of years old.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. So he's saying those are the magic elements. Supernatural.
Yeah. Oh, no. The sniper wasn't over 100 years old. He was, what was he, a Vietnam vet? I can't remember. It was something stupid. It was so stupid. And he lived through the power of photosynthesis. Not madness. Science.
Perfect explanation. Well, then in that case, Vamp, if that's science, then so is Vamp.
But I think they specifically make sure to tell you that Vamp is just a vampire at one point. It's like the crazy thing about it.
Understood, Adam. He's like, maybe he's just... Yeah, he was born a vampire, but like, that's not...
Wasn't he also like... I can't remember. Was he bisexual? That was part of his character, too?
I believe so, yeah.
That's such a strange game. Two.
Yes.
Metal Gear Solid 2 is one of the most nonsense games ever made.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's pretty great.
Yeah. But, like, the end in Metal Gear Solid 3, you'd think he was... Oh, well, he was a ghost, I guess. But was that just, like, a representation of PTSD or something?
What?
Remember the end in Metal Gear Solid 3?
Oh, yeah, I thought that's what he was... Isn't that the sniper?
Oh, okay, then what was the name of the ghost?
the pain, like, I think.
Oh, it had the pain. Okay, yeah. I wonder. I don't know.
Where you fight him on the river or whatever.
Yeah. And you have to walk by, and there's a ghost for every enemy you kill.
Oh yeah, right.
So if you do pacifist, you don't run by anybody. But there's also ghosts for all the animals you've killed and eaten in the game. Like it's cool stuff.
So insane. Like, yeah.
Hideo Kojima.
I love Metal Gear Solid. Yeah.
None.
For those reasons. And I want to play Death Stranding for that.
It seems
reason.
Like Death Stranding is just chock full of that craziness as well. But it's hard to be patient with Death Stranding because it's not anywhere close to as cool as Metal Gear Solid.
Right.
Metal Gear Solid at least has the shell of like a 90s action movie.
Yeah, exactly. And a badass spy.
Yeah. I don't know what Death Stranding is. You're a pizza delivery man played by a guy who looks like a meth head.
Huh, what am I missing here?
Oh,
stuck again?
Don't you have missiles? Is that a missile door?
There's no door. I mean, I can get through that door.
You explored everywhere you can go.
There's just a dot on my map.
Right. It's weird because the dot on your map last time didn't indicate where you were supposed to go.
Yeah, that's very true.
So, I don't know what to believe anymore.
Alright. That's what I just watched. It's just because it's so dark.
Also, you can't tell that at all from the fucking map.
No, that's where you caught, but that's how I came up was through this room.
Oh, I see. Like, it's not as smooth as a regular Metroidvania, or as a 2D Metroidvania.
It gets there, but It totally isn't. Yeah, because it's because of the story.
Right.
Because it gets interrupted and like, by 20 minutes worth of story.
Yeah.
And the fact that you can't. Yeah, I don't know.
Oh, right. You want to switch back to OBS? I'm just watching this walkthrough.
Yeah. I had to watch the little bit of the walkthrough.
Okay. I'm like, it's roughly equivalent, too. What a ludicrous thing. Okay, this is the ghost fight in 3 took forever for him because he went out of his way to kill as many things as possible.
That's awesome. That's just awesome. There's like a consequence for that.
I think by the time I played Metal Gear Solid 3, that was one where, or is it 4, where if you played on easy, they just gave you a trank gun with infinite ammo right off the bat.
Yeah, maybe.
I think I didn't actually kill anyone in 3, except for the bosses.
Is there, like, any brightness setting? I don't think there is.
Maybe. You just have to do it through the TV.
So I think my TV is pretty bright already.
It won't help the stream at all, and I can see barely anything.
How do I get in there?
Do you?
Never mind, I can just go right through there. I see.
I don't see, like, it's hard to notice things.
Energy tank acquired. Yeah, that's the other way. I swear it gets brighter. I remember way brighter halls.
And he says 3 had some insane challenges, like never being detected in your entire playthrough. Oh, I mean, every Metal Gear Solid has had those kind of challenges if you want to get big boss ranking at the end. Nobody does that. Or nobody who's not crazy does that. But, like, in Metal Gear Solid 5, I went and I got the triple S rank on every mission or whatever.
That's insane.
It was so fun. That game was so fun to play.
It really was, yeah.
And, like, by the end of that game, like, when I, because I was just replaying missions to get the higher ranks, but you could do it with all your crazy fancy gear. Like, I could just turn myself invisible, or I could, like, summon buckets from the sky. Like, you're so powerful. And then I would have her, like, quiet with me or whatever, and she'd just be sniping people.
Ah, I see. They're endless.
Oh, it's like a gauntlet. You have to kill their spawner. Or can you not even kill their spawner?
Oh, yeah, I'm pretty sure you can. Yeah.
That's one dead chunk of flesh on the wall. I've never understood with, like, alien movies that take place on ships. It would take ages for, like, a fleshlight compound to form on a mechanical wall. Like, that wasn't just a pure quip.
Yeah, I don't think they're it's flesh, is it?
No,
but it's more like poop.
You think something walked by and, like, sprayed it up on the wall?
No, I think a bunch of creatures have been living on there, and they just keep, like, pooping and...
Maybe.
Having babies.
So it's just a wall made of alien fertilizer.
Yeah. Oh.
Maybe.
Oh no! The bridge! Oh.
Oh, it's just like the end of Resident Evil 5.
Oh, I remember these guys being awesome because you can just jump on their heads.
Oh, those are the enemies from Metroid. Like, I recognize them.
Totally, yeah.
Yeah. That's great.
I guess that was, like, Team Ninja especially tried to have as many enemies you could recognize.
That's cool.
Because he was such a fan. Yeah.
I think that you have your light now. Yeah, it seems a little lighter. Henley has a friend that was close to finishing off a no kills, no detections game on the hardest difficulty when the game glitched and he was spotted. I mean, clearly your friend just told you the game glitched and he was spotted. Also, you can just save your game and resume on those things. Like, although, like, that's why I've never finished Dishonored 2. I was doing a no-kill run, and then at one of my end-of-level summaries, someone died. I don't know what happened.
But that was your first time playing Dishonored 2?
That was my first time playing through Dishonored 2.
And you tried to do a no-kill run on your first try.
I always try. I love going no-kill on those games.
Yeah, but first try is kind of crazy.
Yeah, it's true. I shouldn't have. It ruined it in the end. Yeah, that was an issue.
Can't I get up this? Oh, I can probably just jump like this. Duh. Oh, but do I need to shoot that?
And the thing with Metal Gear Solid, I remember you'd get like the red bandana for doing the no kill challenge runs or whatever.
Oh yeah,
give you unlimited ammo or other cool shit.
There, I fixed the bridge.
Oh my goodness, now you can walk across it without falling like an idiot.
Yeah, I fell like a badass.
Oh, that's true, you landed on your feet.
Yeah, I can use this elevator.
Whoa.
That's nice. I powered it on. Oh, wait.
Oh, this is where... Isn't this where you were before?
Yeah. But I turned on the lights.
Yeah, thank goodness.
Oh.
We should go find some more poop on a wall.
Yeah. I want to shoot some poop.
Yeah. Like, it's a 2D map in a 3D game is a little complicated. Because this game doesn't seem to take advantage of height and things like
that. Oh, yeah, that's true, yeah.
It's challenging.
Yeah, especially when Retro did it so well.
Oh, man, Retro perfected it is the problem.
The 3D map, yeah.
But like Shadow Complex also had some bits where it wasn't entirely 2D.
That's true. Yeah.
And it felt weird in that too.
Yeah.
It's just a hard thing to pull off.
Yeah.
And my brain is used to easy things.
What's wrong?
Jeez. Get off my back, Adam.
Come on, Adam. Just give me access to my double drum, Adam.
Don't call me princess.
Not your princess, buddy.
Not your buddy, princess.
Oh, I'm not your princess, Chapo.
Another elevator.
Pretty convenient. It looks like this is a accessible world you live in. Like, if you were in a wheelchair, you'd be able to get around just fine.
Yeah.
Other than the space monsters.
I don't think I was supposed to go in there.
Huh.
Although there are lots of space monsters in there.
They're holding back that guy with a wheelchair. No!
I don't know. I guess where else am I supposed to go? Alright. Whatever. Let's explore down here. These areas just look very similar.
It's true. This ship is very shippy.
Whoa! Yeah! Oh.
I wish these enemies had, like, ubiquitous names like Mario enemies all do. Like Bullet Bills and Goomba.
They might.
These guys would be called, like, Spider Freaks or Hopping Gorpers or something.
I don't know what they're called. Oh, you landed right on me.
Can they think one of the game sounds resembles a police siren? No, that's just the ambulances near us. They're on to me.
Ambulances, they're coming.
They're coming for me.
They figured out you were injured. Oh no. Oh, run.
Oh god, they're coming for you. They're
gonna heal you, man.
No, no, I can't afford that either.
Get the hell out of here.
How am I gonna garner pity if I have perfect health?
Ha. Huh.
Horse apples.
I'm not totally sure how to land on these guys. Like, why did that pop work?
That time you definitely did. Are there any, like, are you getting money or anything for upgrades? Or is there anything like that in this game?
No. This is the same as Metroid, where you just find them in the levels.
Oh, right. You just find tanks and energy.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Looking good, Samus. Please avoid traveling alone and remain armed. Stay alert to your surroundings at all times.
This is the far future where wheelchairs probably don't exist. If you lose a limb, you just get a good cyborg part. That's probably true. I mean, there's already those crazy, like, spinal harnesses that they've... Like, I don't know if they're actually in production, but that, like, quadriplegic people can wear and they can, like, move around. But that's, like, terrifying future stuff. Like, Boston Dynamics or whatever that company is.
Alright, well, that's it for Metroid, Other M.
That's all you got of the Other M. The Other Mother.
But we got one more game still to come in gaming history.
Is it another mother?
There's going to be some ninja action. So stay tuned.
Oh, that's good too.
We'll be right back.
Whoa!
We'll be right back.
And we're back. Oh, ninja surprise.
Ninja surprise. That's usually not a good surprise.
Ninja surprise?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's true.
Unless it's like a party. But no, most ninjas aren't into parties.
So. We got some Tenchu action going on here. As always with PS1 games, or not always, but often, we are using archive.org.
Yeah, they're all up there.
To play this game. Yep. Almost every PS1 game you can think of.
So for license shit, is that what we learned?
Hopefully. Sometimes this emulator can be a little crummy and it can screw up.
Yeah.
But hopefully it runs okay for you right now. Oh, shit. Damn it. Yeah, see, it's like choppy. But I just realized that I have to do the title still.
Oh, I can get it.
Okay, that might be good. No memory card. That's okay.
That's like the one thing I've never...
Sneaky action.
It's got to be able to be solvable through there, is having a memory card in the archive games.
Yeah, that is kind of weird. You'd think they would.
What's this one called? Tenchu Stealth Assassins?
Stealth Assassins, yeah. The very first Tenchu game.
No box art up on Twitch.
Oh, that's surprising.
Yeah.
Yeah, spawned a whole series of Tenchu games.
Yeah.
Ninja sneaking action games. It's interesting, like, so it was one of the main pioneers, as Zacho says, some sneaky action, in 3D action games. It was actually inspired a lot by the 2D Metal Gear Solid games.
Right.
But it came out before Metal Gear Solid. Or yeah, I should say 2D Metal Gear games.
Right.
And it came out before Metal Gear Solid. So it didn't really have the luxury of copying Metal Gear Solid either.
Crazy.
Which pretty much every 3D stealth game did after that. And also, it's kind of an interesting... it's notable these days because with this... With the game Ghost of Tsushima being so huge.
Oh, yeah.
This company that made these games is called Acquire. And they also made a game series called Way of the Samurai. And it was on the PS2. So it was kind of their thing back in the day. It was basically making Ghost of Tsushima type games.
Yeah. Although Ghost of Tsushima is, I think, or I don't actually know, but I think is much lighter on stealth than this one.
Oh, I forgot. Let me just see if this even works. I forgot to unmute the other audio.
Oh.
They can't hear this. But I think they can now. It seems to be good.
Let us know if it sounds crazy, everybody.
Yeah, it might be choppy because of the emulator.
Right. That's not our fault.
But as long as, yeah, your voice is split. It looks like it's, yeah, it's split. Okay.
Split voice.
Tenchu Stealth Assassins. That's why it's kind of a big deal. Yeah, it was ahead of its time in a lot of ways.
Like, that guy on the cover. The guy on the cover is crazy looking.
He really is.
A weird shape.
He looks like a PS1, a 3D PS1 character.
Yeah. Yeah.
Uh-oh.
No controller sync?
Shoot. Had it all set up.
I sure don't have
such thing here. Okay, now it just sounds a bit choppy, but that's just because of the emulator.
Right.
There we go. Controller's working.
Huzzah!
Out of there. Tenchu! That's how he said it at the top.
It's not a stealthy way to say anything.
No, that's true.
It's more of like a Tenchu.
Should I play as Rikimaru or Ayane?
Ricky Martin, for sure.
No, I feel like Rikimaru is cool, but I feel like Ayane's cooler because she doesn't cover up her face.
She's not very stealthy.
She's equally as skilled as Rikimaru. She just doesn't need to cover up her face and be that. Like, she's naturally more stealthy.
or she's going to be worse at stealth.
Level 1, punish the evil merchant.
Oh, man. I'm going to take all his products.
Yeah. He's evil.
He's evil. He's got it coming.
Like, this feels like it could just be a mission in Ghost of Tsushima.
Totally. Although, there's going to be a million times more stealth in this. Merchants, no matter how wealthy, cannot become Way of the Samurai was a really interesting game, actually, as well. Because it was, like, a very realistic samurai game.
Right. Their whole thing was, like, yeah, making... Japanese historical Japanese simulators.
Yeah.
I mean, the Tenchu had more supernatural stuff.
Right. Yeah.
Mystical stuff, but they still, but like, so does Tsushima.
Yeah.
They still played within that life area, that range.
It's true. Man, I wish there was more of the mystical stuff in Ghost of Tsushima. Although it looks like that's what the multiplayer mode is.
Wow, so. I got a lot of things I can choose from. Grenade, caltrops, poison rice.
Oh, don't eat the poison rice.
Colored rice.
Oh, that's what you want to
eat. Take
some
poison rice. Couple of shurikens. Oh, wow, I got 12 left. Cool, I'll take both the health potions. Take some caltrops.
You just take everything? It looks like you're taking everything.
Take the grenade, take the smoke bomb. Oh, wait, what? Only four four types of items can be carried.
Oh. I see.
So, I might as well take all the poison rice and caltrops.
What do you do with poison rice? Do you throw it at them?
Oh, wait, I don't want all the caltrops. How do I get down there? Oh, I can probably just move it here, yeah. Yeah, I'll take all the things.
Caltrops are such an awful thing to think about. Like, could you imagine stepping on these like spiked metal balls?
Yeah, that's pretty horrifying.
It's really bad. It's like super Lego.
Yeah. It's, yeah. Avoid the main gate, use the grappling hook. Oh, I missed the third one.
Uh-oh. That was the key one.
And I believe, I mean... This controller is only set up for my for the D-pad, but I believe this game was before six, like before the DualShock or whatever.
Oh, for dual analog?
Dual analog, yeah.
Right. Wow. Times have changed.
So it kind of controls strangely. It's like up and down. It's tank controls, actually.
It's the second 3D game in a row you've played that uses a D-pad to control.
Yeah, it's true. But this is tank controls.
Oh, it's just direction based on the camera or whatever, yeah.
Yeah, left and right just turn the camera.
Straight makes you go.
Straight makes you go, yeah. And back makes you go backwards.
Can you do jumps and flips?
You can. Oh, that's pretty sweet. You can do like an awesome backflip. Oh, they killed me. Oh, no, they didn't. I don't know how to block. I did it there, but I don't know how I did it.
Maybe holding back. Could be fighting game style.
Yeah, it seems. Yeah, that might be it, actually.
I have played Tenchu once upon a time, but not much.
Oh, I think it was just something I would move on.
It's. I do associate the PS1 with more brutal difficulty than I do the N64. Like.
Yeah, it's true.
Does look mean.
Oh, I got I think one you're of them.
You're probably supposed to not get noticed, I'm thinking.
Yeah, maybe. I just didn't see anybody. I just walked out and then a dog attacked me and a bunch of guys attacked me. Yeah, I gotta be sneakier.
Until Mark of the Ninja and Dishonored, I was never able to do stealth in the game. And those games are like 10 years old. So there's a lot of stealth games. I just can't do it. I can't grasp it.
They're usually hard. Oh, what? So did I lose all that stuff?
Oh, man.
So I shouldn't probably take everything.
Paco suggests to use the roofs if possible.
Oh, yeah, like a ninja.
Yeah.
Never harm the innocent. That was the third thing. Oh, yeah, I forgot I had a grappling hook. That's right. Useful. You go like that, man. And then...
I know we've covered this previously on stream, but I love ninja games.
Yeah, like that was awesome. Now I'm up here.
No dog's gonna get you up here.
Yeah.
I hope. Now go punish that merchant.
I have no idea where I'm going yet.
No.
And the draw distance is so brutal.
Yeah, just keep going into the black fog. Nothing bad can happen.
Oh god, oh, there's a dog down there. Almost fell. Where the hell am I going? Oh, here we go. This is maybe interesting. I'm up too high to see anything.
Oh, it's just draw distance can't handle the...
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Oh, no, I fell down. Oh, okay, here we go.
Combat. Use your shuriken. Oh, no, you ran out of shuriken.
Yeah, nothing. I have a smoke bomb.
Use your smoke bomb.
But I could run away.
Yeah. That's what a good ninja does, isn't it?
Where the hell? I just don't know where I'm supposed to be going.
I think you smoke bomb and then grapple up to the roof.
Oh, I could do that. Oh, jeez. Oh!
Oh no.
Sliced me right out of the air.
Yeah.
Ow, ah. Oh, he's good. Yeah.
These guys are way too strong for you.
Oh, it's a health potion. Yeah. Can I cut through this? Nope. Oh. Yeah. Yeah. I have a lot of health.
That's important.
Guys again. Oh, the dog.
Not the dog.
Not the dog. Oh.
Here.
Oh god. Where am I supposed to go?
I have no idea. Everything looks the same.
Oh god.
Is that dead?
No, I got that's only like half health.
They just sent you flying so far and so slowly. Was that guy coming through the wall?
Yeah, a little bit.
Maybe you just have to sneak through the wall and find the merchant.
Ah, the ninja way.
Yeah.
Oh! Didn't work. I don't think I can ninja rope out of here. Whoa! It's pretty crazy that on the PS1 game you could just. Like, you can ninja rope anywhere.
Yeah.
It's like a grappling hook that just. It's just a crazy like hook shot. Oh, I think I lost them.
Does the music change?
I don't understand this, like, all the symbols in the bottom left corner either. It's like exclamation mark.
Yeah.
Oh, I think that means like you should be sneaky. And there is like a sneak. I can sneak around.
Oh, you're in the light right now, so they can see you if they were looking, or
maybe, or like, or I feel like triangle's a warning. Yeah, and then question mark's like he's lost me. He's like, oh.
Right.
Or he's not hasn't lost me, but he's like curious, wondering what that was. Uh-oh. Oh. I like that move. Nice roll. Lacko says you're a ninja, so. What is that? I think covering. Sneaky way is the best way, yeah. That's
but it's hard to sneak way. When you don't know where you're going.
Uh-oh. Oh, shit. I clicked out of the game. That's what happened.
Uh-oh. Like it's impossible to sneak because you don't know your destination.
Oh no. They found me.
Oh, there you go.
It must be in there. Oh, there's an arrow. I got shot at with an arrow. Okay, I'm gonna try to jump up to this rooftop. Oh shit, what? Oh shit.
Uh-oh.
Oh wait, no, that's where I was before. Wow, that's cool. I jumped over that wall.
How'd you get out there? Yeah.
Wow, I got that guy to attack his friend. My awesome jumping skills. Yeah, he did it again. Oh shit, I'm gonna die again though.
Damn it.
I was hoping to just get above here and then I could lose them and then I could just fall down. But I don't. Okay, I'm just gonna try to explore this area with my last few breaths. This is it. Come on!
Oh, it's all because you're this non-face. You're just so easy to find.
Terrifying.
Payback time.
Somebody help!
Get her!
Oh, right.
Get her!
Looks like you chose the wrong party to crash.
Looks like you chose the wrong party to crash.
I guess I have to deal with you first.
Oh!
Well, he was attacking you before the cutscene ended.
Oh.
So oh, God.
Pizza! Pizza! Pizza!
Oh, man. It's so loud. But
it's a very challenging thing.
I don't think your audio is not that loud. Alright, they're just cheering me on. With pizza and screams.
Pizza and screaming.
So I wish I could just start for the whole game from the beginning. Why would I? Like, I haven't made any progress in the levels.
Right.
Unless people stay dead or something.
But have you killed anybody?
You know, just how much, approximately how much does each ad give? I don't know. Do you get like a dollar? No, it's less than a dollar for
oh,
sure.
Way, way, way less. Yeah.
It's like 15 cents maybe?
I think less than a cent probably.
Oh, maybe, yeah.
Per ad play, yeah.
Oh, right, yeah. I meant 15th of a cent. That's what I meant.
Oh, there you go. Okay.
Oh! I killed the dog. Nobody saw me.
The dogs.
Okay, I gotta get to the roof. Yeah. Okay, now where was that? Not that? Seems like it would be that, because it's like the biggest building here. I'm right in the middle. Another dog. McKinley says, I scream, you scream, we all scream for pizza.
Oh boy. I
pizza,
do
pizza, pizza,
pizza,
yeah. Although... Uh-oh. That dog sees me, but I snuck away. Oh no, somebody else. Oh God, there's a guy right there.
Oh no. It's all falling apart.
Oh, somebody else sees me. I think this game seems pretty forgiving, though, as far as, like, if one guy sees you. It was like, I think Metal Gear Solid kind of set that standard of, like, you set off an alarm and everybody's on you.
Right.
In this, it seems like you kill a guy and then it's like you're back to being stealthy.
Thank goodness, actually. So stressful in Metal Gear when you have to go and hide for 60 seconds or
yeah,
whatever.
Like, see, I've got now everybody's down to question mark. Oh,
right.
I'm pretty sure, yeah. And there's a number there too.
Ugh.
That must be the guard or whatever that's showing there, and how far away he is from me. Oh, see, that dog sees me. Oh shit, yeah. See, and then. It went to double exclamation mark red, which means he's coming for me. Then I dumped behind here, and it went to pink diamond, which is
What's Pink Diamond?
Yeah. That was like, he's on high alert. Now he's back to blue question mark, which is just like alert. Like he's looking right for me. I killed him. You know what else is interesting about this game? So Sony published the first one in Japan. Like I said, Acquire developed it. But after that, they sold it to Activision, who did Tenchu 2 and then the first Tenchu on the PS2.
Yeah.
And Acquire only did the first two Tenchus.
Right.
But then they sold it to From Software, who's had it since 2004.
Have they done anything with it?
They have. They made the most amount of Tenchu games, actually.
Oh, they made 2004, that's right.
But they haven't made it. Yeah, I think that the last one was like a Wii game, I think.
Okay.
And before that was two 360 games and like a PSP game. None of which got good reviews. Although Acquire did come back for the last game, which I think was the Wii game, and it did get okay reviews.
Right. The only one that's coming to mind, I remember one called Tenchu Z.
Yep, that's one of them. Yeah.
Yeah. But everything else is just a blur.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, so it did spawn like a bunch of games, but there hasn't been one since, I think, 2008.
Huh.
2009, somewhere in there.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, that's like a lady. Oh, no, she's just alerting. Settle down,
that's
lady.
That's not allowed. Yeah, cool. Your...
Oh, she alerted this dog.
Oh, now you're
attuned to the feelings of ladies.
Done for.
Oh, no, and she alerted that guard. Oh, this is a mess. Now I just need to find that and find the place. And
the
freaking
merchant.
Yeah.
Have you haven't found the merchant yet.
I did that last time.
Oh, okay.
But then his bodyguard got in the way and killed me.
Yeah. Oh, right. Immediately.
Yeah. But I had no health.
Right.
Oh, so I don't... Oh, God. Ooh, okay. Well, I didn't get hit there. Don't want to be in this garden area. That's a no-go. Oh, is it just over here?
Oh.
I think it might be. I think it might have been really close to it.
So you could, in theory, beat this level in like a minute, probably, if you...
Probably.
Right. I wonder if there's a way to just drop in on this guy without being noticed by his guard.
Oh, that'd be cool. McKinley says, if stealth games have taught me anything, it's that... If you're a guard, you should scream as loud as you can as soon as you see a body or intruder instead of taking the time to tell people on your radio or set off the alarm. Very true.
Yeah.
You'd be a good guard from all your stealth game playing.
That's right. No, I would just be like, who turned out the lights? And then I'd go and turn on the lights and go back to what I was doing.
Again, this is, does this game have Ninja Studios? Or like Team Ninja, you mean? Level proportions for the NPCs? No, they. No. These guys are all about... trying to be historically accurate. Whoa.
Somewhat historically accurate.
Well, yeah.
Just
to play in like
stuff.
A historically accurate sort of fueled world. Yeah.
Right. I mean, who's
history.
To say that ancient
oh,
Japanese
God.
People didn't invent breast implants?
Terrible. That was really bad.
The combat is just crazy in this.
I wonder if I should just run into that room.
You could, yeah.
How do I sneak up on that guy? What? He was just right in front of the door.
Is he taking advantage of that lady?
He's trying, yeah. Gosh. He's evil.
Somebody help!
Get her. Somebody help! It's great voice acting.
It looks like you chose the wrong party to crash.
I have come for Ichigoya, but I guess I have to deal with you first.
Oh, God. Yeah.
So much for your big mouth.
And you should just get into this place with some good health, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, Maybe I should just quit there instead of retrying every time. I'm assuming maybe retrying is why I don't get my stuff back.
Right. Yeah, then definitely you should do that.
And I'll try one more time here. Okay. So, start here. Oh, shit. Damn it. Go down this hall. Somebody sees me. Oh, yeah, there he is. Okay. He's so shadowy. Oh, God, no! Why didn't I... How do I... There we go. That's what I was trying to do. Oh, look, it's a stealth game. Oh, no. Oh, is he going to turn around? Yep. Yeah. Here we go. This is where
slit
we
his throat.
Yeah.
Is it that simple?
Oh, yeah. It's weird. I did some of the training earlier, and I did go into like a stealth cinematic kill kind of a thing.
All right.
But that time I didn't. But I still killed him in one hit. So that's good. I'll take it. You just can't see more than 2 feet in front of you.
But maybe the enemies can't either.
Well, yeah, but that's the thing. You can't see them until they can see you.
True.
Yeah, I should go over here. Wow. That was cool.
Very good.
Oh no, he sees me. Oh,
did he?
God. Yeah, he shot an arrow at me.
Man. Yeah, he's shooting you
already.
He's
still shooting at me. I lost him.
Is he going to come for you?
Doesn't look like it.
He's just out in the abyss.
I can't tell, yeah.
He says he's always found it interesting how in stealth games, after finding the corpses of dozens of coworkers, people only look for you for like 30 seconds.
Wow, he totally lost me.
It's a hard life. I bet these guys in feudal Japan aren't being paid very well, so they're not going to look that hard.
Yeah, I haven't been hit yet.
Good show.
Oh shit, where am I getting seen from? Oh shit. Oh no. Oh yeah. That was awesome.
Yeah.
Like I said, the stealth kills are really bloody and gory in this game. Even
the blood
like,
looks like
there's
like
a lot of blood.
Balls of blood.
Looks like what?
Balls of blood coming out of them.
Yeah. PS1 style blood.
Delicious blood.
I just know what a sense of this area because it's all so dark.
Yeah.
Oh, some stuff to smash. No, maybe not. Hiding place, I guess.
But like, if you're getting chased, you only have to run like 10 feet before they lose you. Who needs a hiding place? I can't hear it, but is the music cool?
That's pretty cool.
Sweet.
Yeah. wonder if I'm missing something to trigger like a... I don't think so, though. L1 and R1 change my things. Oh, R2 is just another way to sneak. Oh, yeah.
There you go. Really thinks your sword is magic and makes their blood congeal instantly.
Oh, that's cool.
Probably likely as well.
Just like the ninjas always did.
Just like the ninjas.
It's historically accurate. Am I stuck in this area?
There's gotta be... Can't you go up?
Yeah, I can always go up, but...
I don't know. Well, that door popped open when you ran past it.
Yeah, those are those, like, side areas.
I wish you had, like, a map.
Oh, maybe you do. Yeah, you do.
Oh, but... A map with, like, a legend.
Yeah, it's not too useful, although... No. I'm assuming that big building on the left is the one I want.
Yeah, it looks like where I'd be if I was a pervert merchant.
Yeah, that's right there, right? Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, there's this guy. Nice. Maybe I can get him from above. Wow, these buildings are very close together. Makes it very easy for ninjas.
Yeah, I guess. Also, it's probably for their children so they can have a can phone between their windows.
Oh, that's fun.
Yeah.
I didn't realize
he only asks if it's PS1 or 2. If it's PS1, that's pretty good graphics. It's PS1.
Hey, there you go. Boom!
The graphics are good. The only issue is the draw distance.
Yeah, exactly.
That was a great way to kill a guy.
Yeah.
Used both of your swords on him.
Oh, yeah. Oh, no.
What happened?
This guy saw me.
No. I don't even notice when people... Like, how do you tell?
I'm just watching the... Oh, no. It finally hit me. That's the first time I got hit.
Damn.
I'm going to learn how to block. I'm just going to see. Hold back. Yeah, that is how you block.
That fool.
Nice. Like I said, that was one of the kills. Nice. I got one of the sweet stealth kills. Oh,
very sweet.
This guy's a jerk.
Sweet and stealthy.
I totally blocked that. Oh no. I wonder, should I just. Can I just run in here? Come
on. I don't see what's stopping you.
And then hopefully I only have to fight this bodyguard.
What? Who are you?
You've been a bad boy. It's payback.
You've been a bad boy.
Somebody help! Get her! Get her!
The voice acting is really good. The wrong party to
crash. I have come for Ichigo.
Those were the only times I could have gotten into voice acting. Back when the standards were hopelessly low.
Oh no! I guess I should instantly start blocking. Oh god, he's destroying me.
Oh god. It's an insane.
Oh no, why am I fighting him? Oh!
Probably.
This is really hard. Okay, wait.
You're still alive.
Grenade, grenade. Grenade! Oh! Killed me.
Oh, you
beat so much for
my. Oh, you're on fire. Oh, wow.
Mouth. Okay, this time I'm not gonna, continue. I'm gonna quit. I'm gonna try the other character.
Oh, Ricky Maru?
Yeah, Ricky Maru. I guess I could do training, but training didn't even really teach me. I was just as confused.
Yeah, I wouldn't. Have you ever seen Rikkyo?
No. What's that?
It's a great movie. It's like a old Hong Kong movie that's like badly dubbed and everything, but it's crazy gory. It's called Rikkyo, the Story of Ricky.
Oh, nice.
But like, it has like people ripping each other in half and like ripping arms off to kill people. Like, it's crazy.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
I think it's Sonny Chiba who's in it. Is that that's
if
the
I
famous
put,
guy, right?
Like rice on the ground, will people just eat it?
Oh, and get poisoned?
Is that how the rice works?
Yeah.
Get my caltrops this time.
Yeah, I just found a great... I'm going to tweet a GIF I found of Riccio.
Sweet.
So if people want to look
explain,
at
a... It'll explain everything?
It'll explain why it's a movie that people should watch.
Well, this guy's pretty cool, too.
I just don't know if the GIF is playing is the problem. Like, we'll see.
What's this building on my right? I want to go down here.
Yeah, this okay, I tweeted place. The picture. It worked.
Oh, shit. Whoa. Oh, God, what the hell just happened? Why did I turn around?
God, bad controls. It's those damn tanks.
Oh no. Oh, nice. Oh, can I do a sweet corner kill? I don't think I can. Nice. I think that's. Oh, this isn't the right building. Shit.
Oh no.
I lose him in here. Where are you? Never find me.
All right, I need to stop looking at Riccio GIFs. Time to get back to watching the stream. I tweeted two pretty great GIFs though. So if anyone wants to see something that's fairly messed up. Yeah.
Got that kill. Where the hell am I going? How is this not the building?
Yes, so it's basically a movie with Doom style gory kills slash Mortal Kombat fatality. It's kind of Mortal Kombat.
How did I not hit that guy?
It's a lot wackier than Mortal Kombat.
Oh shit. This is all gone to hell. Is this the building? Is this the other side of the building? Nope, it's just not the building. I'm so confused.
It's just not the building. Every building looks the same, too. Except there's that one area that's like four buildings in one enclosed area, and then there's the big building.
Shit.
Oh, no.
Where the hell? I know, but that's the building I just went into looking for the guy.
Yeah.
Was the big building.
It seems like this guy is... faster in combat than the girl.
See, well, he seems bigger. He can just
throw
his sword around.
And, like, close the distance on the enemy.
See, like, yeah, I thought he was in this building last time.
But this building was usually white in the inside when you were playing as the girl, I thought. There's an enemy in there. They saw
that's
you.
That's the woman.
Oh.
Yeah, it's not this building, I guess. So confused. Okay. Then I don't know where what building to try.
Oh, I wonder if it's different depending on which character you play as.
Maybe. Try some of these buildings. Oh, hello. Oh, I got a health potion.
Perfect.
Oh, shit. Yeah, that was awesome. Oh, God. Couldn't follow it up, though. No, he's destroying me.
Alright, I got a list of controls here for Rikimaru. You got your standard movement, jump with axe, square sword slash, circle with stealth, triangle to use item. Up makes you run, like pushing twice in a direction. I'm assuming you already know that.
Yeah, yeah. He has those kind of like a dash.
Do you know how to do a stealth roll?
Yeah, he holds circle.
Okay, jump slash, long jump. Long jump slash, fast stab attack.
Did pretty good there.
Wall jump, okay, so nothing too crazy. Alright, level 1. Mission 1, you'll start a place near a wall. Then you use grappling to climb on the wall and head to the right way of the wall.
Extra health potion. I needed that. The boss. This thing?
Jump into a square hole in the floor to find the enemy.
Oh, in the floor.
Yeah, this is the full walkthrough for the mission. In level 1 mission, you'll start a place near a wall, then use your grappling hook to climb on the wall, then head to the right way of the wall. In stealth or running motion, as long as you will not be detected by enemies, and after you've reached a huge house in your left.
Hey, I found it.
Oh, perfect. It's all because
I didn't look at the map, though, to see where it was. I guess it's the long building, though. Somewhere in the long building.
I'm here to avenge all the innocent.
I'm here to avenge the innocent people you've hurt.
I want a short. I can't remember the cake lyrics. Like I want a girl with a short skirt and a long building.
My business is with Echigoya. Step aside.
So which one's the merchant?
Have to kill you.
The Echigoya. Not this guy. This is his bodyguard.
The one in the poop-colored robes?
Yeah.
That's Echigoya. No, just a guy with a spear.
Yeah. Oh, God.
More guys with spears.
I nailed that guy.
He's still alive.
He's still alive, but I did much better than... Oh, no. I got him.
Perfect.
It's very close. But so yeah, if I have to kill Echigoya, oh shit, yeah. Oh shit. No. Oh god, he's gonna kill me. No.
Echigoya.
It's not even Echigoya. It's just the last bodyguard.
Just the regular spearman.
I got him, but I have 3 hits.
Do you have any healing potions left?
No, I used it by accident. Oh man, if only I had it.
Well,
Echigoya.
I don't even know where he ran off to.
Gotta be something in here. What's that? A cat! Ah!
Don't kill the cat!
Is he gonna kill me?
I don't know. I think it's a shooty.
Oh, there's a guy behind me. The cat distracted me.
The cat was a distraction.
Ninjas. It's hard to be a ninja.
It really is.
Can't be distracted by cats?
I'd fail as a ninja.
Yeah.
Just on that.
Totally.
I've been noticing in our like complex here, as when I walk our dog in the morning, there are so many cats.
Oh,
it's terrifying. Like when I take the dog out in the morning, we run into like 5 cats every day now. They're just out and about roaming around. Okay. Yeah, world's gone to the cats, I say.
All right, I feel confident about this one. So I'm going to take some good stuff.
What good? Are you starting? Did you start again from scratch?
No. But I was kind of careful that first round.
Hedging? Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So I think I go... Whoops, this way? No, I meant to go the other way. Hey, Zvra! This is no attention, no way! Get out! Get out of here! Yeah, we're fine.
We're trying.
Attention came out this week in gaming history.
What year? Was it like a million years ago?
Let me just get the exact date here. August 31st, 1998 in North America.
Jeez, man. That's so long ago.
And what day is it? Yeah, September 2nd. So yeah, 3 days ago it was its anniversary.
It's 22nd anniversary. That's crazy.
Yeah, it's cool. I've never played it before. And it's you can really see
that you've
why
it
was influential. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Why it's one of the series.
Totally. Like, yeah, you get a lot of Tenchu, or no, Sekiro energy from it.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I feel like Sekiro is the most Tenchu thing since the last Tenchu game.
If it wasn't for... Although the sword fighting seems pretty prevalent in this too, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah, it totally is.
I'm assuming you played it back in the days, Vra? I'm surprised I didn't. I played the PS2 one, and I never really got into it.
Right.
But this would have been right up my alley.
It's true. Ninjas are always cool.
Okay. I swear he's in this.
And it's not movie. Like it's not like you'd have been a kid and seen a ninja and been like, no way.
Zvon says, yes, but thinks they played the other one, Wrath of Heaven. Yeah, I think that was Tenchu 2. It was called Wrath of Heaven.
Yeah.
Which, interestingly, I was reading, is just a... way to translate Tenchu.
Oh, weird.
So it could just be called Tenchu Tenchu.
Tenchu Tenchu is a way better name, just like Metroid Other Metroid.
Exactly. Alright, I think it's this building, but maybe I approached it from the wrong spot. Yeah! Oh,
wow.
Yeah, he really...
Yeah. Poor sucker.
There's gushed blood.
We got a gusher over here.
Still don't quite understand where to go in this level.
It's all wet and gushy. Congealed blood.
It's this guy. I remembered this guy was here. Oh no. Oh shoot. Oh, that went really bad.
It's so easy for it to just flip on a dime.
Oh no, now there's an archer destroying me? Holy crap. Okay, I think I can just make it into this room. No, that's the wife room. Damn it.
But then also the enemies follow you into this fight.
Oh no, I'm back over here. I didn't want to be over here. No, I don't... Or maybe they do. I think he calls in guards no matter what you do.
Oh,
extra guards into that fight, but maybe they do.
I see. In the guide I was reading, it recommends you jump into the room through a window.
Oh, right. Sleeping. Yeah, I still haven't even noticed that.
So if you can figure out a way to do that, whatever the heck that means.
Where the hell am I? Okay. I can only think that it's... Can't shoot this thing down. It's on this building somewhere. Oh no! Oh, I'm okay.
Wow, it's so dark right here.
This game, you mean?
Yeah, but like this specific spot in the game when you were just seeing Rupe. Oh.
It's a cat.
Just deal with any sleeping enemies.
Wait, I need to look at the map. Oh, okay, that's where I am. All right. Yeah, there's the hole.
Come on.
Did it. But this is still going to be hard, though.
But going, it seems like taking the roof right to this is the way to do it, though.
Yeah.
I'm here to avenge all the innocent people you've hurt.
Right. Somebody I don't even have to fight anybody.
Get him. Get him.
It looks like you choose the wrong.
But it's like impossible to finish this stealthily too, which is kind of annoying.
Step aside.
Yeah, this is like a boss fight.
Blacklist leaving.
See you, Lago. Thanks for watching, as always. Thanks for voting. Of course, as always, there'll be a new gaming history board tomorrow you can vote on. Oh, no. Oh, he really packs a wallop. I didn't end up, I had a healing that time, but I wasn't able to use it.
Damn.
I can totally do this in the next 15 minutes.
It sounds like the level keeps going after this, too, though. Well, doesn't Echeveria run this away part, or whatever? Least. Oh, yeah. I don't think it goes for much longer.
Yeah, I just gotta kill that guy.
And he's just a fat merchant who likes to be a creep. Yeah.
And I can get back on the rooftops again.
In the guide, they called the guy you're fighting a slasher samurai hired by the merchant.
Yeah, like saved, like restarting didn't help. It's the character switching that made the difference there. That's brutal.
You almost have, so you have to reset the ROM completely.
I guess. But how would you do that?
No, that's brutal.
If you just, like, yeah, does that just, is it permanently on your save file?
I guess, but you don't even have a memory card, so I don't know.
That's weird. That's cruel. Alright, but I still got it. Oh. Turn there.
Whoa. Like, anytime you're up on the roofs, you really can't see much of anything.
Oh, you have to totally depend on the map.
Yeah.
And then it's... Oh, yeah, that's easy.
Oh, yeah. Now the hard part. Is there anything you can do to tilt this in your advantage right off the bat?
I don't know.
Could you use, like, shurikens or something against him?
Maybe. I feel like that's just going to kill me.
What? Who are you?
I'm here to avenge all the innocent people you've hurt.
Somebody help! Get him!
It looks like you chose the wrong party to crash.
My business is with Echigoya. Step aside, or I will have to kill you.
Oh, what even happened there? Oh, come on. Yeah, I just destroyed him. Yeah, and no other guards show up. You're right.
Where have you hidden?
Huh.
That was totally because I, yeah.
Stealthy.
Was stealthy that I only had to fight him. That's much easier.
Can you escape through the roof again?
Did I kill the woman?
Why would you kill that woman?
She's alerting everyone. Oh, I chopped off her arm.
She's having a crisis.
Wow. Well, I stopped that.
It's true. She's not having a crisis anymore.
Can I, think I can zipline back up here? Oh, yeah, I can.
Sweet. But we don't know where Etcha, whatever his name is.
No.
And you're not going to see him from up here.
That's the problem. Where did he run? Probably in this area, the garden. Seems like a good place for a showdown, right?
Yeah, totally.
Oh shit, he's on. This guy's on. Oh no.
Echigoya is in an area with two small houses. He's in. So, if there's an area with two houses on your map, that's where you should go.
Diamond, yes. Alright.
Oh, thank God.
Two small houses. Oh no, there's an arrow guy. Shit, where did he come from?
That arrow's huge in you.
A tiny, tiny butt.
I would run around looking at houses. Oh, time to get out of here.
Nice. I'm surprised that I pulled that off. Okay. What did it say? Two small houses?
Yeah, I have more specific directions.
He's got to be in this area then. The only place with small houses is this area.
Right.
Oh shit. What? How did that not hit him?
Just be sure to kill the other enemies before fighting at Chigoya.
Oh no.
So running into these guys isn't necessarily a problem.
Oh,
but
or
dying
is it? Oh, come on. Oh.
Does the enemy block most of your hits also?
Yes.
Okay.
Where
the fuck is
arrow? I had 10 minutes. I gotta be able to beat the first mission.
What a nightmare! You just get to Echigoya and he's a boss, and that's the mission.
All right. So I guess I just retry then.
It's a little worrying reading about him.
Yeah.
Well, I want you to discover it on your own.
That doesn't sound good.
Yeah. But he's got less HP than the slasher samurai.
Alright.
I think after you've killed the slasher samurai, you want to go out through the roof, and then I think it wants you to go right. But it's written in such bad broken English that I really don't know what it's asking.
I don't quite understand the running either. Like, when I double tap forward, he does like this kind of quick step.
Like a Naruto dash.
But then he seems to just go back into his.
Oh. His regular. Can you just run. Keep doing it?
No, I've tried that too, yeah. Or I guess you can, but I don't know that it's faster. And you can do it backwards too.
Ooh.
There's the cat. I don't think I can skip this. Oh.
Uh-oh. Lovely wallpaper.
Shit. Fuck. What just happened? I think it just crashed.
Oh,
maybe
man.
I did it. I'm trying to skip stuff.
I wouldn't think there'd be a controller function that would do that.
But, yeah.
That's rough. And by rough, I mean stupid.
Yeah, I don't know that it's worth bringing it back up.
Might not be.
It's gonna. It takes like 5 minutes to load.
Oh, right, because it has to download the ROM or whatever.
Damn.
Too bad.
Well, that's the tough part about playing with the... With the archive games.
Exactly. And no save files.
Yeah, and no save files. Damn it, I was totally going to beat that mission.
You were getting there. Like, you were getting further each time.
Would have done it.
You could still do it to prove it to yourself.
Yeah. Yeah. Wouldn't be the same.
Not at all.
But that's it for the show, basically.
Yeah. Yeah.
A little bit early.
Yeah. Such is life.
Yeah, that's the way it goes. Thanks for watching, everybody. Thanks for the comments. Zvra, Lacko, McKinley.
Yeah. Yeah.
Green Rabbit.
Yeah.
And,
I feel like Duboyo was here.
Duboyo, yeah. He just whispered in our ears and talked about Pokemon sex. I mean, Masters of Sex.
Masters of Sex.
Yeah.
I love that. Yeah. I love that Michael Sheen show, Pokemon Masters of Sex.
Anime.
Yeah.
Okay. Thanks, everybody. That was great fun. Tomorrow there'll be a new gaming history board. You'll be able to vote on it. And we're going to play more games next week.
Yeah, but we're not until next Wednesday.
Yeah, that'll be the next time we're live is next Wednesday.
I'm going a week off in between.
Into the woods, yeah.
You gonna do some ranching?
Yeah, hang out in the woods for a while, and then we'll come back, do some gaming history, maybe play some Resident Evil, maybe play some Jackbox. It's going to be great. So join us next week, everybody, for more Antsy Pants and his Quarantine Jam.
What? Better game in there.